Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live. Thank you so much for joining us. We are here Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. And then, of course, we then return to the airways every evening, 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. And we have got a jam-packed transmission lined up for you today. We have James Stewart joining us. Mark Anderson, Jim Tucker, Dr. Corey Gold, and more today. And of course, Jim Tucker and Mark Anderson of American Free Press are coming on because they are the tip of the spear when it comes to covering and ferreting out the latest on Der Bilderberg. And that is only about 2 months away. It's usually in the first week of June, sometimes last week of May. And every 4 years, they're set to meet in North America. Am I going to have to weasel back into Canada up there to go cover this thing and be screamed at for 15 hours in customs before the media all shows up? Then it blew up in their face because they did that. Also, Rawsome Foods, James Stewart, arrested in $1 million warrant. That's why he's going to be joining us. And now they're raiding other places selling raw milk, which you can buy at farmers markets around Texas. I've got a whole refrigerator full of it. Here comes the feds, folks. Unbelievable criminal government. Hey, why don't you go after Bernie Madoff? Oh, you can't really go after him. You've already got him in prison because you guys had to flush him because he would have been able to blow the whistle until he was a convicted con. Now nobody believes him on people like John Corzine. Why don't you go after him? So we're going to be going over all of that as well. And then we're going to get into the poisoning of the food supply, vaccines, and more with Dr. Corey Gold today. That is all coming up. Now, if you go to the front page of Infowars.com and scroll down to the featured news section, you can see today's top news. The shocking face of China's brutal one-child policy. And, you know, some people will say, oh my gosh, you're showing an image of a dead baby. It's horrible. But killing the baby is what's horrible. They take the living born babies and they go on record and find women who are hiding babies, if it's their second or third child, and they put them in a bucket until they asphyxiate on the water. They drowned. And then they take the babies and they render them down into cosmetics, medical products, and flavoring for your cool, icy, delicious beverages. The flavoring industry. And the globalists are doing this because it's spiritual what's happening. They believe if they can get you to eat something evil like this, that they've defiled you and corrupted you. It's kind of like something out of The Golden Child. Eddie Murphy movie, which I don't believe there's big devils flying around, you know, physically. The point is the elite are into all this stuff. And that's why they're doing it. And they believe they can get a nation to do this and consume their young, that they've got you. And notice it's like, don't show us dead babies. Let's just call them blobs of tissue. And now it's, well, don't show us babies killed after they're born. And then it's, we're going to kill up to three-year-olds that are totally healthy, but don't show us the three-year-old. And I understand that it's shocking, but it's our First Amendment and we're showing it, and it's an English language exclusive at Infowars.com. So we're going to cover that first when we come back, and then a bunch of other news. It's all coming up today, and we've got four guests. Stay with us.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand, eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Coming up in 1 hour, we're going to give you the latest with some breaking news on Bilderberg 2012 as the global elite prepare to meet. In early June, probably in North America, there's some rumors of Haifa over in the Middle East. We're going to have Mark Anderson, editor at American Free Press, and senior editor Jim Tucker, the granddaddy of Exposing Bilderberg Group, joining us in the second hour. Dr. Corey Gold in the third hour. James Stewart is going to be on at 11:30, who was arrested and given a $1 million bail to be able to get out of jail for selling raw milk for decades publicly to even people I know in Los Angeles. That's the thing. This criminal government can trump up charges on anybody anytime they want. And that doesn't intimidate me. I'm ready to be killed and tortured by these people. I will go down in history as a martyr. And when it's all said and done, I want Nuremberg trials, and I want these people all sent to prison. We will defeat the criminals run by people like Don Corzine, who is above the law, John Don Corzine, who could steal billions of dollars publicly and not get in trouble. The government openly grows opium on television in front of everyone. On record, Afghanistan 10 years ago went from 10% of production, 9 to 12%, depending on the graph, to 90-plus percent. Some estimates are as high as 95. Most are 92% of world opium production. In fact, listeners won't believe it. For PrisonPlanet.tv viewers, for radio listeners, type in Afghanistan now supplies 92% of opium. It'll be BBC. Type it in. Let's just show people, because I know the FBI is listening and watching right now, and I don't want them giggling in their offices because they know this is all true. But they must be shown it in their face again. So when the troops start complaining and Pat Tillman starts complaining, they had to grease him. And that, of course, came out because the Army coroner wouldn't lie and said it was a homicide. So the good news is there are still people. There are still people. Did you find it? There are still people. Here, I'll do it right now. Watch this on Google. I'll do it myself. Watch this. 90% of world opium production. Yeah, you can just aim the camera over here and I'll show people. There it is. Opium cultivation out of control, UN says. Yeah, if you just type in 90% of world opium production in Afghanistan or 92%. Boom. MSNBC, Associated Press, blow it up for people watching. Boom. Opium cultivation out of control, UN says. Really, being loaded on all those UN aircraft, Afghan crop total, 92% of world supply, exceeded global consumption. They got so much of it, they can't even sell all of it. And it was right at 10%. Why am I getting into this now? When all this came out, they had to kill a bunch of troops and military investigators, a whole bunch of them. And then the containment didn't work, so they just came out and said, yeah, we grow it, we load it on aircraft, but it's for America. And there's no discussion about, well, then why if they catch you with heroin, do you go to jail? Well, that's because they got to keep the price up. Now, that said, yesterday I'm shooting the nightly news right before it airs. And one of my IT people, one of my six IT people, comes in and says, the FBI wants to meet with me tomorrow. And I said, what about? And he said, well, you know, before I worked here a year ago, you know, because I did the interviews, I was doing, because we hired somebody who already had a job because we were paying more, who builds websites for the biggest bar owners in Austin. And he does great work. So I said, yeah, build websites, do code for us. I hire him. He comes in and I said, okay, well, you can either get a lawyer and refuse to go, or you can go and just see, but I'm going to imagine it's going to turn into an Alex Jones discussion, not bars and people I've never met. And I said, at that point, if they start telling you you're a criminal with something made up, I said, the issue is anything you say that's even halfway wrong, they've got unconstitutional laws where they say, oh, lying to the FBI, kind of like filming police, they put you in prison for life now in Illinois. The law doesn't even say that. They got juries that'll do it. I mean, half the country's zombies. So I explained to him, I said, you do what you want, but when I come into the conversation, it's going to be a news item. I said, don't bring me up. You may get FBI people that aren't criminals because they got compartmentalized ones that do, you know, the local drug stuff, the local bank robberies, kidnapping, stuff like that. But I said, if I come up, obviously I'm going to talk about it. Well, he met with them this morning, and about a third of the discussion is about Alex Jones and how they listen every day and want me to know they listen. Oh, gee, you didn't think I didn't know you listen? Like, I don't know what I'm dealing with? Like, I haven't had special forces jump out of the bushes and set fires and try to blame it on me in Florida. Like, I haven't had probably 30 times police try to get me to talk about attacking other police so you can put me in prison. Like, I haven't had Marine Corps officers in plain clothes try to get me to attack the State Department with them when I'm covering Bilderberg. Get this through your fat brains. I am an American patriot. I am the good guy. I am as pure as the driven snow. I'm not doing anything, even under your criminal system, that's a fraud, illegal. Get that through your head. They get some idiot on my website threatening a cop, the one that shot the black guy in the back and said he had attacked him. The guy was in handcuffs on the ground. Cop executed him in a fit of bloodthirst. Now convicted, spent, what, 1 year in jail, already out? Some idiot. Post that. Our moderators take it down as they do everything calling for any type of criminality. The FBI calls me up and says, we want you to put that back up. And I said, no. Go ahead and make up whatever crud you want. I'm not going to put something up with a cop's home address saying go after him. And I said, if you've got your subpoena, come get it. And they said, we're coming with a subpoena. I said, good, bring your subpoena. Then they start calling around the office. They weren't asking here when they were calling random numbers of my crew. The FBI from California was not calling, asking about the guy's thing about, you know, go to the cop's house, here it is, and getting. No, they were asking about the Obama deception a week before it came out. This is what they are, little commissar officers, little political officers who want to intimidate my First Amendment. Hey, move to North Korea. So they go on and say, yeah, we listen every day. We listen all the time. We want Alex to know that, and we want him to not talk bad about us today. What in Hades is that? You want to try to creep me out? Which you've done the opposite. I just got about 5 months of energy off this. And then it turns into, and why am I talking about this on air now? The FBI shows up here last time about the subpoena and wants to know why we have posters of Obama up on the wall. And I said, well, number one, how do you like your narcotics trafficking buddies? Hey, you know, your FBI buddies killed that cop and the doctor and others, Terrence Yakey, up there at Oklahoma City. You know, would you like the police officers' names I've talked to where the FBI came in their office and said, if you investigate the bombs in the building, you and your wife are dead? And the FBI guys are like, and the Austin cop that was with them is like, okay, we don't want to discuss this anymore. I'm like, oh, it isn't time to scare me anymore. I want to know if you're with the people that kill cops. They were basically scurrying out of here when they were done. I don't care what you do to me, okay? You understand that? I'm not a coward like you. I've committed to this fight. I know I'm right. And your crud with my employee only confirms it all. And maybe you're so deep into intimidating people that you just think it was cute and funny that you like the show and you listen every day. And you really listen every day and don't say bad things about us. Maybe you want me to talk about you on air. And then you sit there and say, don't give Alex this Austin detective's number. Like I want to have a detective's number. I got the police chief's home number and cell phone in there. Like I want to call. The Austin police chief's asked me out for dinner to drink a beer. I don't have time to do it. I'm too busy looking at photos of one-year-old babies they're killing in China. I'm too busy breaking reports how the U.S. government plans to start killing kids up to age 3. Why don't you investigate some real crime? I get mad because my life has been stolen from me. You think it's fun to deal with a criminal government? You think I don't know? You think I haven't been punched in the nose and kicked in the side by kickboxers and told to shut up about Walter Smith, Judge Walter Smith, and his trial, his kangaroo civil trial with the Davidians? Just because I went up and bullhorned a judge, 4 people come in to beat my head in? I already know about the New World Order, buddy boy. If you think you're going to intimidate me, you better check again, because you got the wrong person. Anyways, then they start telling my employee he's a criminal and done things wrong on just, not even something with the case, with the place where he webmastered and all that, just some nothingness that wasn't even anything. It was some domestic dispute with one of his friends and you know, trying to defuse it. And they want him to go report on himself, the Austin police, so they can turn him and say, you're going to go to jail if you don't go plant something in Alex Jones's office. They didn't tell him that, but I know that's next. And you're on record, okay? And I've got lawyers out of state with money waiting to sue you personally if you try to set me up. You got it? I got your number. I see right into you. Do you understand?
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
We all know that Berkey water purification systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey guy offers amazing specials for Berkey water filtration systems. The Berkey light systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey light system today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey light, the Berkey guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at goberkey.com. That's goberkey.com today.
HempUSA.org has moved and expanded its operations for faster worldwide shipping. Our product line has grown from 5 to nearly 100 items in less than 5 years. Our food is grown naturally, always chemical-free, not found in stores. Great for daily intake and perfect for your emergency storage shelter. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powder, seeds, and oil can do for you.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Mark Craighead, founder of Crossbreed Holsters. I designed our top-selling holster, the Super Tuck Deluxe, to solve the problems of being poked, pinched, and gouged while carrying concealed. The Super Tuck Deluxe is the most comfortable, most concealable holster on the market today. We offer a 2-week free trial and a lifetime warranty.
Visit us at crossbreedholsters.com. Don't forget, crossbreedholsters.com.
In a coming apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, tow line, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
Bergstrom Airport and start searching the military transports coming back from Afghanistan if you want to find some drugs. Find that all that cheap heroin flooding out on our streets that the government grows publicly, loads on aircraft, and flies here publicly. I mean, the Russian consulates have publicly complained and said, please stop shipping it into Russia. I'm so sick of it, and I'm calling the whole thing for what it is, a sick joke. But I know it's all funny. I've seen government reports that have come out where people that know their phones are being tapped are still schizophrenic. That happened to a famous writer. I'm having one of those moments where I can't pull up the name, even though I've read so many of his books. The Old Man and the Sea, the one about the Spanish Civil War. It's gonna Ernest Hemingway. And it turned out they were harassing him, dirty tricks, breaking in his house, listening to his phones. And he talked about it, and they grabbed him and gave him electroshock therapy, the FBI did, until they fried his brain. That's J. Edgar Hoover for you. Because J. Edgar Hoover loved destroying Hollywood people, artists, because it was part of his power trip. While he dressed around in women's clothes, you know, pranced around at home with his boyfriend. They hate stars, they hate powerful people, they hate good people, because that's what it attracts. That's the type of people, on average, that want to go around and be the good guys, but are really the bad guys. And then they've always got the idiot core of the FBI, who are actually are so dumb, they don't know there's a bunch of narcotics trafficking, child kidnapping, money laundering killers above them. I mean, this Justice Department that wants me to know they listen every day, gee, FBI agents locally, I'm on the White House enemies list. That's been in the newspaper. The White House has responded to me. They have Media Matters attacking me every week, who infiltrates groups from within and destroys them. Gee, I get spies and generals calling me up at midnight. I talk to 15 million people every week. Do you think I don't know the government's listening to my radio show? And maybe 5% chance out of 100, these are nice FBI agents who were just like, no, don't talk bad about us. We're not bad. We hear Alex say bad things about us all the time. Well, if you're Jiminy Crickets, that type of guy, let me tell you something, buddy. You need to stop being naive like Gomer Pyle. Gee, Sarge. I was a selfish person. I would get out of this country so fast it would make your head spin. But I have said I'm staying here, and I'm not selling out, and I'm not going to give in to fear. I'm going to go with it and love it. That's why I'm so alive. It's just so idiotic. Those FBI people, when they were here, are like, why are there posters of Obama on the walls? And I'm like, this is a media operation. That's my last film. And you see it's a film. And then, and one of them's like, yeah, no, I've seen it. Oh, but you're asking me what it is. You are the one that has something wrong with them. You're the one under suspicion. I immediately, when those people showed up, everyone, I'm just bowed up to them immediately. Because just like I walk outside, there's a rabid dog with its hair falling out and foam coming out its mouth. Just like I walk up, you know, changing a tire on I-35 and there's cars flying by me. I'm concerned about that danger going by me. And I've experienced it. You know, I grew up watching the police deal drugs to kids. And then I watched them leave the mid-level local drug dealers alone and bust the people they sold to. And I'm tired of it. I'm sick of it. And I know that most of the detectives in this country and most of the high-level police, FBI, you name it, are so criminal, it'll make your head spin. I exposed, like, why are you having drug dogs and searching lockers and all this stuff up here? Why are you trying to force the football team to drug test? You guys are selling the drugs. Oh, well, we're going to slam your head into the office desk and threaten you and say that we're going to set you up for stealing stereo equipment. And then the police started running around saying that I was on drugs. And then they had, through the grapevine, our lawyer told, he called my dad and said, they're going to arrest your son and hang him in the jail cell. And by the way, they've done it to a bunch of people in Rockwall So you better move. And I had to move to Austin because the police were threatening to hang a 16-year-old because I knew they were narcotics traffickers.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months. Simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Pack save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
You are obsolete, Mr. Wordsworth.
A lie! No man is obsolete.
You have no function, Mr. Wordsworth. You're an anachronism, like a ghost from another time.
I am nothing more than a reminder to you that you cannot destroy truth by burning pages.
You're a bug, Mr. Wordsworth, a crawling insect, an ugly, misformed little creature who has no purpose here, no meaning.
I am a human being.
Words, Mr. Wordsworth, that have no substance and no dimension, like air, like the wind.
I don't care. I tell you, I don't care. I'm a human being. I exist. And if I speak one thought aloud, that thought lives, even after I'm shoveled into my grave.
Delusions, Mr. Wordsworth. Delusions that you inject into your veins to make you think you have a strength when you have no strength at all. You have nothing but spindly limbs and a dream, and the stake has no use for your kind.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
I'm going in, through, and beyond, directly into the storm, the maelstrom of tyranny. It is the only way to defeat it. The people are waking up. The info war is on. 5 million guns are being purchased a month. I pray that the globalists don't start a civil war and stage new Oklahoma cities. I pray for good judges that has pointed out the Hatari militia were completely innocent and the FBI lied and set them up and had their informants make the statements and attribute it to others. And I pray for my family and I pray for myself, but more importantly, I pray for justice. We're going to our guest who's under globalist attack in a great way, an evil raw milk seller. No victims, but Big Pharma that owns Big Agra wants you to drink the sludge they call milk. They don't want this healthy real milk catching on, so the attack is on. Amish are being SWAT teamed, facing decades in prison. Families are being SWAT teamed, million-dollar bails. Amish publicly selling to their neighbor, just vicious, vicious, vicious Soviet-style thugs are upon us. Speaking of our own government and the Bioethics Journal saying, yes, we need to kill babies up to age 3. You're an extremist if you don't want healthy babies to be killed up to age 3. I'm not joking. We broke that a month ago. It's now mainstream news. The shocking face of China's brutal one-child policy can't happen here. Top academic and eugenicist are calling for what Obama's science czar once advocated. And I'm sorry to have to post the photo, but they even kill babies after birth in China. This is the shocking face of China's brutal one-child policy, which many academics and pressure groups are now calling to be imposed in the West. The image shows a 9-month-old baby lying dead in a bucket, forcibly aborted by Chinese family planning authorities in the town of Moshan. She was just a few weeks away. They injected it. The baby still lived, begged, was crying. They put it in a bucket of water. Because the parents of the baby already had a child, they were hunted down. This is what they're calling for here in the U.S. To comply with China's draconian one-child policy, the mother was injected with a poison that induced an abortion. But after the baby was pulled out inhumanely like a piece of meat, this is a U.S. exclusive, English language exclusive, it was still alive. See, Paul's wife's Chinese. She gets him all this because she reads it. It was still alive and began to cry before doctors slung the defenseless child in a bucket left to die. That's how they do it at the partial birth abortion mills. They throw them in a bucket to die. Of course, in China, it's come out they save the babies, too, for medical experiments living. But again, they're not human, according to our media. You're a conspiracy theorist if you say it's a life. See, the sickness, torture's good. Secret arrest is good. John Corzine can steal billions, it's good. Cancer viruses and the vaccines. And the public, those that aren't awake, will not awaken because they'd have to admit everything they were told was a lie. The timestamp of the image tells us the baby was killed Monday. The image began circulating today on Weibo, China's version of Twitter, which has around 260 million members. The story was attracted widespread revulsion directed against the family planning authorities responsible for the murder of the baby. I have U.S. family planning videos, and we're going to our guest that we've shown, where our government admits they funded these policies in China, set it up. The agreement was they'd make them the new power base, because they'll leverage out the rest of the world industrially and then force that model everywhere. See, but the lowest common denominator forces that model everywhere else. And where they talk about how great it is they've killed the babies and how great it is. This is from the 60s before it was even law in the 70s. And they hunt you down. The UN does it in Africa. And I see BBC articles, the ignorant Africans run when the UN comes to give them vaccines. And it's all the women crying, all our babies in the village, over 100 women were, you know, over 100 women were pregnant. Some only about to give birth in days. All the babies died. Some of the women died. Women have been known in Africa, when they're hunted down in the jungle and given the shots, they will then run and chop their arm off as quick as they can with a machete. And of course, then it came out the UN was doing that. This is your murdering government, your global corporate murder system. And all of you that think you're going to serve the system and be part of the power structure, when they release that mega bio weapon and you're rolling out and you and your whole family are dying and the New World Order has its way and we can't stop them, I want you as you die to get right with God and admit you were wrong. That's the key, is that you know the truth in your heart. That's more important than anything. Now, shifting gears for a little bit in the next hour, and we got our next guest coming on. Rawsome Foods, this is an exclusive. James Stewart arrested in $1 million warrant. And I'm ranting here because I'm angry. And just to tell you the story of what happened and what happened to him, here he is joining us. The $1 million thing to release him. They're charging other people now. Natural News reporting on this. Do we have Mike Adams with us as well? I'm so wound up, I don't even know here. Okay, let's go to James Stewart. Good to have you on with us, sir. I appreciate your courage to come on and discuss the evil crime of selling raw milk for many years to people and what a horrible criminal you are. Thank you for joining us.
You're welcome, Alex. You know, I appreciate you and the show, and I know that Mike wanted to be on, but I think he's busy at the moment.
Okay, well, tell us what happened to you. A lot of folks know, a lot of folks don't know about Rawsome Foods and the fact that they're treating you like you're, like they should be treating John Corzine.
Well, you know, it's true, but I mean, the same thing is happening now and yesterday, by the way, in Ventura County with, if anybody goes online and reads David Gumpert's blog and Mike Adams's comment last night, it seems as if you can't even, you know, the FDA 2 years ago, just so everybody understands what's going on, they have decided, and it's on record in a court case, that you and I have no right to make any decision what we want to put into our body or our children's bodies, that the FDA has the ultimate authority. And that's where all this is coming from, along with pharmaceutical industry and whoever else. You'll never get to the bottom of it because they won't agree with what, or let you know what the real truth is. But I love your passion, Alex, and it is true. In August 3rd of last year, after being raided the year before, they came the year before in 2010. They came in with dozens and dozens of agents, took over the place.
That's the famous video with the guns drawn, and you didn't shut down. So now they're going to try to make you an example, putting you under the jail.
Right. Well, a year later, after that guns drawn raid, they came in and arrested me on 13 charges, and those charges stem basically from raw dairy products. You are correct. And I got out 3 days later, and basically they took a 24-foot stateside truck, and there are videos on YouTube attesting to this, because people were, all the members of Rawsome were there looking over the fences with their cell phones and video cameras and whatnot. They loaded up this truck with almost every food product that was at Rawsome and took it to a dump in the valley and got rid of it, although next door to us is a place called Bread and Roses, which is a place that feeds the homeless. So instead of taking the $100,000 worth of food they stole and dumped, they could have fed the homeless next door. Meanwhile, the food was gone, and now, let's see, I went to five court appearances on the fifth appearance, which was March the 2nd, while we were scheduling another date. Two sheriffs jumped over the bar and arrested Sharon Palmer and myself in this show of grand force. And, you know, and it just was this scene. So we then were put downstairs, and I was put in jail for a week and a day. And Sharon didn't get out for 3 weeks on charges that now there's a conspiracy to commit money laundering and grand theft and you name it, million-dollar bails on me.
And what they do is they go to your employees and say, we're going to put you in prison for made-up crimes if you don't lie about your boss. And they can connect it to people that aren't even involved. They'll just go tell a neighbor, we're going to put you in jail if you don't say this. It looks like I have the FBI trying to do that to me right now out of something that I'm not even connected to. That's how they work. They just go down the line. Yeah. This is who runs our government, just absolute evil.
Well, you know, Mike Adams and I have been talking a lot recently, and, you know, it's an interesting question, Alex, why people are not aware of what's going on back in the 60s and 70s when it didn't take much time to figure out how to demonstrate for, let's say, a war in Vietnam and get that shut down. I believe people are in fear, harassed, intimidated, living in their comfort little lifestyles, and they don't understand that it's coming to them real soon. And when you see what's really going on, it's not just me. You're right. It's the Amish farmers. It's let me give you the other little example of what happened. You heard about Farm to Fork, right, in Nevada last year?
Yes.
Okay, so it doesn't matter.
People try to have a party and bring their organic food, like the old-fashioned country cookouts. We still have those in East Texas where everybody, you know, at the end of the summer brings meat, brings food. And now they have this global, this is what Stalin did in Ukraine and other areas. And China, the UN has said, use food as a weapon. For those that don't know, they actually come and raid people and dump their potatoes, rutabagas, everything in the trash, acting like it's toxic waste.
On private property. They do this on private property. If you don't believe you're protected, if you're on your own farm or your own house or your own land.
No. That's the rural, that new rural commission that Obama set up, where he admits the Homeland Security and the Pentagon is over all farms.
No, I listened to Sheriff Richard Mack last night on a half-hour show that was on Mike Adams's, or maybe it was on your show, I don't remember. And here's a man that's talking about, you know, sovereignty and all the other stuff. I have to let everybody know that when I was taken this time on March the 2nd and incarcerated for 8 days, I never mentioned the word sovereignty, but let me tell you what happened. Not only downstairs in the holding tank, they started accusing me of being a sovereign, which is now a terrorist word, okay? So what they do immediately is they put you with a different kind of armband. You're a danger to the community, even the community inside the jail system. So they put me in holding cells for minimum 3, 4, 5, 6 hours with basically no warmth. They can learn how to torture you these days without actually physically touching you, and that's what they're planning to do, and they did it to me. I do have to admit, when I was transferred to Ventura, that I was better treated up there, but still, the whole entire system is now, as you know, and I love your passion about it, Alex, is on the verge of, as I guess as many people 200 years ago said, how about Ben Franklin? I gave you a republic if you can keep it. What me people need to do is stand up right now. They're not standing up, and I don't understand why. And it's too obvious by listening to people like you and myself and whatnot what's going on. If you, those that sleep on their rights don't have any. And if we don't stand up as a complete group of people, we have to stop the infighting that's going on involved ourselves in our own alternative industry. People are fighting amongst themselves. Division is what keeps them from winning. So we all have to join forces with each other. I agree with you, Alex.
Well, you're right. And again, it's the Obama administration establishment of White House Rural Council to strengthen rural communities. And it says in the press release at whitehouse.gov, Homeland Security, Department of Defense, rural spies, commissars. And it's now happening. They're arming all the little agencies. We are the enemy. We don't even really deer hunt, but we have a small area that we lease out of our old ranch / farm in East Texas. And now they have federally controlled game wardens who just show up and treat you like a criminal and demand to come in your cookhouse and get in everybody's face. And it's just government wants you to know we own you. Got it? Now, the way I heard Mike Adams describe this is they kept you in freezing conditions, sewage running in, all of this. And this is what they did to Bradley Manning, which has been admitted to be torture. They call it pain compliance. They break arms and call it pain compliance. I have video of this. This is what America is.
Yeah, I did see some brutality inside there. I was not actually treated brutally as far as being kicked or in some way, shape, or form horribly attacked physically, but they've also learned how to do that in ways in which you're isolated for 6 hours in a cold cell at 50 degrees with nothing warm to keep you warm, so you're freezing with hypothermia. Yeah, they then overflowed the toilets in the area of the jail that I was in, where there were 2 to 3 inches of, I'm not joking, shit and pee floating all the way into the bottom of my cell, so all I could do is stay on the bed. The smell was insane, and they didn't come for 4 hours to clean it up, okay? And then when they do clean it up, they give you the same mop that they're mopping up the shit with to mop up your cell, and that's supposed to keep you nice and sanitary and clean at this point. Obviously, it's a complete joke inside there. There is brutality inside there as well. I did see some guys' heads being smashed up into walls and whatnot. But
and let's be clear, these are colleges that create more criminals. We have the biggest crime wave in the world. We have the biggest prison population. The government and banks ship in the drugs publicly. Wells Fargo and others launder it. Don't get in trouble. This is all in our face. And you're selling milk and papayas and things. They're charging you for all of that. Papayas, everything is evil. They're raiding other people now. What are you facing? Because you're facing, tell folks about the bail, the $1 million, what's happening to you. They want everybody to know you're going to eat GMO and you're going to die of cancer and you're going to love it.
That's exactly right. This whole grandstanding event that went on, and then the bails were set at, they're just insane. The idea that I should be $1 million bail, but they trumped up 37 felony counts all, and that's why they can justify it. But let me ask you a question. Did John Corzine have any bail? Did the peanut company that sickened 700 people and killed 9?
And of course, now they're going to go after you after hours of interrogation. They'll claim you lie about something that they'll just twist, or they'll have one of their drug head informants lie about you and say you're, murdering babies.
That is very true, and that's what they do. So you are correct. When people listen to you, they have to understand on the show that you're not exaggerating anymore. This is not exaggeration, folks out there. This is what's really going on now. And people, I'm hoping people aren't viewing this as just entertainment. This is going to come to you soon as well. People need to stand up and do something.
Well, it's already coming to them. The GMO, all of it. Some pediatric cancers are up by 10,000%. They're murdering our children all around us. FBI agents are going to lose their kids to their shots. They love dying. They love the system.
You don't need me to tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
We all know the importance of having storable foods, but what about when the food runs out? What then? For real food independence, you need a supply of non-hybrid seeds. Introducing the Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com. The Survival Seed Vault is sealed for freshness and includes 20 varieties of easy-to-grow non-hybrid seeds for only $37.95. For less than $40, you've got real food independence. And the Survival Seed Vault includes detailed planting and seed-saving instructions. Imagine the barter power you'll have when the food supply does collapse. Right now, save $9 instantly when you buy 3 or more Survival Seed Vaults from MyPatriotSupply.com. Same-day shipping on all orders, plus free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Or discover more emergency preparedness products at MyPatriotSupply.com. That's MyPatriotSupply.com.
Do you know which 37 crucial food items are going to fly off the shelves when the next disaster hits? If you don't, you and your family may be without food and waiting in long food lines after a big disaster strikes. You would be surprised how many people don't have these food items right now. 123survivalplan.com has set up a For Patriots Only video with inside information on the 37 food items that will sell out first when the next disaster strikes. The video on 123survivalplan.com has crucial information you and your family need to prepare for any disaster, natural or man-made. And you won't have to be afraid of going hungry or being sent to a FEMA refugee camp. See the video that over 1 million other smart patriots have already seen in the last 4 months. Prepare now. Go to 123survivalplan.com and learn which 37 food items you should hoard. Easy to remember, 123survivalplan.com. Again, that's 123survivalplan.com.
I'm the voice inside your head. You refuse to hear.
tell you, James Stewart's our guest, and you can cover what's happened to him at Infowars.com. You can find out more at naturalnews.com. And we're not exaggerating. It's like the lady who was facing 6 months in jail for a garden in Michigan. People thought that was a joke. They thought the big journals, medical journals, coming out and saying kill children up to age 3, even when they're healthy, if the parents or state want to. People are like, this isn't real. Yeah, it's real. Okay? I'm risking my life to bring you this information. This isn't a joke. And if America would just wake up, the criminals in government and corporations who work together couldn't get away with this. And I've seen all the videos. I've read the affidavits. They're all online. I mean, this was a mainline place. I know people in L.A. who drove there and bought stuff. Vegetables, milk, all of it. I mean, this is an above board. It's like the Amish guys selling to people. They call it an undercover year-long operation where the guy's selling to people with undercover folks acting like they're their neighbors, selling them milk. In fact, guys, if you bring me a jug of milk and a glass out of the refrigerator, I'm going to drink some here on air. I gave some to the Austin police chief. Didn't the Austin police chief drink some? Yeah, when I had Art Acevedo in here, my memory fails. Didn't that happen when I had Acevedo in here? I was like, here's raw milk, you going to arrest me? And he thought I was joking. And I said, you're going to have troops on the streets, Art Acevedo. And he said, the sky would literally have to fall for that to happen. And now we have troops at the Kite Festival. Let's go back to our guest and one more segment with him. James, what can we do? What are you facing? Where is this going? How can we help you against the food police?
Well, you know, first of all, you know, I don't understand why there's no pro bono attorneys that, like, you know, and I won't mention names, that are not trying to come to the aid of whoever out there, myself or anybody else, because it's necessary at this point that the masses stand up and take their power back. They never really lost it in the first place, but people are, it seems to me, afraid to actually stand up, and that's why we have the issue and the problem that we have, Alex. People are not willing to stand up, and I don't mean just regular people. I mean anybody, including the attorneys. Everybody needs to get involved in this and start making sure that it doesn't happen. Put a lot of effort into defending these people, whoever they are, myself or anybody else for that matter. You know, I don't feel like I'm the isolated person out here. I see all the stories all the time that are going on. You know, I'm not going to stop. And, you know, that's just my personality. I feel the only way to change things is to put something into action. And that's what Rawsome was about. Rawsome was putting it into action. Other people intellectualize what they know is going on, but they forget or they're afraid to put something into action to do something about it.
Well, they've shut you down now. They're trying to put you under the jail. Tell folks what you're facing, websites where people can support you.
The charges in both cases now in Ventura and L.A. add up to probably 40 years in jail, which I doubt seriously. But at the same point, you know, that's what they could
do. Well, they got juries that would send babies to a gas chamber.
Yeah, I know. Well, I don't understand that either, by the way. How can juries be that, you know?
It's gladiatorial. Even though they're going to be destroyed by it next week, they enjoy burning people. It's a demonic nation.
It is crazy, my friend. So they can get in touch with Mike Adams at Natural News if they want to help donate their time, their finance, you know, the financial situation. Mike Adams would take care of it for us.
We're going to be back in 60 seconds, 5 more minutes for you to make any other points you want. James, I know you haven't done any interviews, and I know of. I appreciate you coming on here. We're dealing with a guy who publicly sold people what we buy right here in Austin, and he's facing 40 years.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
This is Alex Jones with 5 good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number 1, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number 2, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3. In some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number 4. Dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5. A solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Coming up in the hour, we're going to have the one, the only, Jim Tucker, and the editor of American Free Press, Mark Anderson, on with us to give you the latest inside scoop on Bilderberg coming up this year. Right now, we're talking to James Stewart of Rawsome Foods there in Southern California. You saw the images of the oranges, the papayas, the mangoes, the milk, the chicken being thrown in the back of the truck to be taken to the landfill. Because they dare sell organic food that people grew on their own farms and brought in as a collective to then sell. Because the government has to be over that. The same FDA that raised the level of radiation and said it was safe, just like the EPA did. Oh, radiation level goes up from Fukushima? It's safe. We just said so. DU safe. But for heaven forbid you drink raw milk. The thing is, this is totally legal. They're now trying to get them on money laundering and stuff, or lying to federal agents is always the same. Like when I had the FBI here one time and they were bringing up other subjects, I said, oh, I can't even talk to you. You'll just say I lied to you. So I just started telling them about their crimes till they left. James, what's the outpouring been like? Because your story's been on the Drudge Report. It's been on the news. I mean, it's been all over. I think it's really woken people up.
Well, I hope so. You know, it wasn't my intention to do that, to wake people up. It was just, you know, a food club that wanted to provide high-quality food. As you mentioned earlier, by the way, Alex, the entire Rawsome Club was basically a membership-only, private membership-only club, you know, and so therefore, you know, the public couldn't come in.
I mean, swingers can go to a private club and have sex with each other, yeah. But you can't sell in a private club potatoes.
Well, exactly, or anything else, especially surrounding raw dairy. Really, that's the crux of it now. But eventually, it'll be something that is a non-GMO product. You know, you got to consume just GMO, and that's it. Rawsome always looked into what the problem with the food was. You know, by the way, let me share you briefly, so most people don't understand this. Words and terms are misleading. The word raw is misleading. The word cold-pressed is misleading. Why is it misleading? Because nobody has legally defined these terms. So when you go buy what you think is a raw product or cold-pressed oil, it's not. And that's the problem. The problem is anything under pasteurized temperatures is fair game to be called those things, and it's dead food. And yet,
well, that's like calling total GMO natural.
Correct. And so what Rawsome was doing was looking into the source of everything and bringing that information forward and trying to find the highest quality products for everybody.
And you were getting popular, and so they said, just like the Liberty Dollar, even the Wall Street Journal said it was totally legal to have the Liberty Dollar. It wasn't masquerading as a U.S. currency, and that guy's, you know, going to be sentenced soon and sent off down the river. I mean, they're going after everybody.
Yeah, popular is correct. We were becoming very popular, and after the raid of 2010, which is an obvious fact, we became even more popular because they shoot themselves in the foot by attacking everybody, because then people wake up and realize what's going on.
Only got a minute left. I want to have you back up for the full hour soon because you're a really smart guy. And I just want to hear your view on other things, hopefully before they send you off for 40 years we got to pay for in prison because you sell milk. Never a victim. They're not even saying anybody's hurt. Final statement here, James Stewart.
Alex, I heard you in the beginning of the show talk about food and what's missing in our food. Everybody needs to understand, you can eat 75% less food if it's high-density quality food, and minerals is the main key. All I really ever wanted to do was provide information for people about what the highest quality food is. ask yourself the question, what's the purpose of eating or drinking anything other than the taste, the smell, the ambiance, the fun of eating it? It's getting nutrients or nutrition out of the food. This is food. Why are they after people who are providing high-quality food? Because they don't want you to be well.
Let's get you back up sometime next week for a full hour to take phone calls if you can. James, God bless you. We're going to find out more next week on what you're facing. Thank you so much.
Come, Alex.
All right, there we go. Set him up for next week, please.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that it could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at SurvivalSeedBank.com. That's SurvivalSeedBank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
If you just joined us, we had James Stewart, a guy with no criminal record, who has now been raided twice and is facing 40 years in prison and was let out on $1 million bail, $1 million for selling papayas and potatoes at a private food club and raw milk. That, by the way, is legal. But they then manipulate all this legalese. I mean, they want to shut down grassroots in this country. The government has tax incentives to ship jobs to China where you get paid to shut down your factory and leave America. Do you think good guys are running the country? In Oklahoma, in Michigan, they're saying, we want laws. You've got to have a permit to have a backyard garden because you might grow something bad. You don't let prisoners have gardens. You don't let prisoners take care of themselves. Folks, You heard Steve Pachanek, famous spy, wrote, you know, the books with Tom Clancy, assassin, overthrew governments, you know, manipulated the situation, according to the London Telegraph, into the death of the Italian prime minister. He comes on air and says America's been taken over by mega banks and is totally corrupt and the government's pure evil. He wasn't talking like that a year ago. Ron Paul talks about CIA coups in this country. We've got a real problem in this nation. Now, while we're lining our guest up, we had some phone number mix-ups. While we're doing that first, and we got big Bilderberg news coming up, I want to direct everybody here. You just heard James Stewart from Rawsome Foods, organic food experts, saying it's all about the minerals and vitamins. And if you believe in what we're doing here and like to fund our news operation and get the best vitamin and mineral systems that I found anywhere while it's still legal, because they're trying to ban it for over-the-counter sale, just vitamin C, you name it, Beyond Tangy Tangerine just has huge dosages of all the vitamins and minerals, the trace elements. And you're not going to find really other products out there that have all those traces in it, because most of the mainline folks say you don't need the other trace ones that are in there. But Dr. Wallach's research shows you need it to have it all kick off and work properly. The Cell Shield RTQ, the best antioxidant system out there. Rebound, great citrus punch, sports drink. It's got super B in it and a bunch of other vitamins and minerals. And it's also got the best ginseng compounds and green tea. It'll supercharge you. Same thing with pollen burst. They're all just amazing. Increases energy, anti-aging, antioxidant, curbs appetite, reduces oxidative damage and stress. That's the pollen burst rebound. All of it available at InfoWarsTeam.com. And you can sign up and be a distributor member for $10 and get discounts. InfoWarsTeam.com. So you can buy the products. You can also sign up and be a distributor, InfoWarsTeam.com. There's also a phone number there on the site, InfoWarsTeam.com. Now, we have got the editor over at American Free Press, Mark Anderson, who did an incredible job last year in Switzerland covering Bilderberg 2011 in June. It's normally in early June, sometimes in late May. Coming up in about 25 minutes, he's going to ride shotgun with us. Jim Tucker is going to be popping in and joining us. Jim Tucker, author of the Bilderberg Diary, and of course, one of the editors there at American Free Press. And we're going to be breaking all of that down. Mark Anderson, again, has just done an exemplary job when it comes to exposing Bilderberg as well. And more as Jim gets older, you know, the torch is getting passed to Mark Anderson. And this is important because Jim Tucker has been shot at covering Bilderberg in Europe, in Portugal. He's been arrested, you name it. I've been detained, arrested, threatened. Had people try to set us up, trying to cover it. This is a big deal, and he's the only person who has real Bilderberg Group contacts. He's able over and over again to tell you what's going to be announced months or years before with exact precision. And I know Mark more and more is segueing, taking the baton from Jim. Jim's still charging out, an amazing person. But Mark Anderson joins us to give us any intel on new developments. There's always the rumors that the globalists will rent a hotel they're not really going to use in another country. Then they'll get another one to divert people in the city, in the country they're going to be at. So here to break it down is Mark Anderson. Mark, thank you for coming on with us from AmericanFreePress.net.
Thank you, Alex. Thanks for having me on. It's been a busy 24 hours. I've been poking around over in Chicago about the current thing, and that's, of course, the upcoming NATO meeting, which very well could tie into this. As Jim will tell you later, Bilderberg tends to operate in the shadows of other meetings because even these wealthy billionaires try to economize and have their Bilderberg meetings not too far away from where they have their other confab. So there's a lot of activity in the Midwest with the NATO summit upcoming in May, but they're having prelims right now. The Chicago Council on Global Affairs met last night. and Nicholas Burns, a former U.S. representative to NATO, spelled out some of the NATO agenda, although in very general, broad terms for public consumption. And they're even having a mini NATO summit as we speak at Chicago Water Tower Place right now.
But they might also have it in Virginia because they moved the G8 that they were going to have with the NATO summit out of Chicago. But every 4 years, it's generally in North America. You're saying your intel is leaning towards the United States, not Canada?
Yeah, Canada's a possibility. They're having the Codex meeting up there in May. That seems less likely now. Jim and I just discussed this. You know, it's kind of draw a card, discard. As you say, they kind of make dummy announcements to try and throw people off the trail. We've heard Haifa, Israel in recent times, that they might hold it there, which is a little disturbing. No reporter likes to go there too much. We don't know how good the security would be. We don't know how safe a reporter would be there in such turbulent times with the situation with Iran and all that. But I think that Virginia, as you say, they moved G8. I thought I had heard Camp David on G8. Is that right, Camp David, Maryland? Is that what you heard, Alex?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and so that kind of splits things a little because they were going to have the G8 in Chicago, as you know, with the NATO summit, the first ever NATO summit in the Windy City. With Rahm Emanuel there, I'm not too surprised, though. He's sort of a regional global administrator for a business outfit called World Business Chicago, which is a bunch of wealthy, you know, elites and a well-connected people that is a semi-official body of the city of Chicago. You know, a typical mingling of public and private, which is what these globalists do. And so the chess men are being moved around the board. NATO is becoming more proactive. They're calling themselves the first responders of the world now, obviously departing from their traditional defensive posture.
As Jim said they would do a decade ago, that they were going to have that be the world army, NATO, and folks are like, yeah, North Atlantic Treaty Organization is going to be the world police. They now say, we are the world police.
Yeah, first responders. That means, you know, when something goes wrong, they're the ones on the scene, but I have a feeling it wouldn't be with ambulances.
No, that's when they fund Al-Qaeda to attack your country, they come in and bomb your country to back up Al-Qaeda publicly.
Yeah. Who knows what insanity lurks in the hearts of men? But anyway, long story short, Jim can give you a little bit more in the follow-up to what I'm saying now, but I'm watching the Midwest, especially NATO, having a preliminary meeting right now at Chicago Water Tower Place.
Have they ever met in Chicago before?
No, not the NATO ministers, not a full-blown NATO meeting. This is the first time ever.
And, has Bilderberg ever met in Chicago?
Not to my knowledge. Ask Jim that one. You know, there's lots of resorts in and around Chicago, big country clubs that have big gates around them. You know, there's a lot of posh little areas as you head up.
Yeah, they made a mistake with Chantilly because we could get up within 100 yards of the meeting area and bullhorn them, and world leaders were coming out and giving me, if looks could kill, I'd be lying on the floor.
Exactly. So, you know, to hit a golf ball in their beer or to drop whatever you want in their champagne, we have to find out where they're doing these things. But as I say, I'll be following the Midwest thing. Jim's going to be looking at Canada a bit. As you say, every 4 years they have a tendency to be in North America.
Well, I know he looks, but a lot of years his source finally just tells him where it is. Bilderberg internally, as you know, just stating what's for the audience, they hold it from even the mid-level people till right before.
That's true. And the way it went in Switzerland last year, where everything from foggy alpine mountains to especially high media coverage and agitation from protesters, when that really drove them out of there fast, they got there late due to the fog as it was, and then they left early. And then Dominique Batic, that Swiss legislator, was demanding to get in. You remember all that. And they were really, you know, they really got rushed out of there in a huff. And, you know, who knows, they're probably, as I've said before, they're probably considering breaking this thing down into smaller meetings. And, you know,
well, we know that's already been going on. If they were smart, that there's resorts that are on multi-thousand acre areas where they could just drive through and be left alone. They're idiots.
Yeah, and next thing you know, they'll stay at a Super A. You know, I don't know what they're doing. It's strange in that sense that they don't just go to a Rothschild estate or an Eaton or Rockefeller's Pocantico Hills, you know, up along the Hudson Valley. Why don't they just go there? I don't know. You know,
well, they like the golf course is why. They always like to have a golf course.
I guess so, you know. Spoiled brethren that they are at any rate.
Well, it's got to be an open resort they can bring hookers into as well. Stay there. We're going to be right back on the other side with the editor of American Free Press, AmericanFreePress.net. Subscribe there. You're not going to get any better Bilderberg coverage anywhere. Then you're going to find AmericanFreePress.net. And then after that, InfoWars.com. Stay with us.
I'd seen the longevity products work for many others, and so I bought a bunch of them, started using them, had a little bit of results, but I wasn't following the regimen every day. But Aaron Dykes in my office did and lost more than 60 pounds. When I saw those results, I said, I better follow my own advice. I started taking the longevity products, and it's been incredible. 37 pounds in 2 months. Our bodies are amazing, and God gave us an incredible gift. But if our body doesn't have the tools it needs, all of the vitamins, all of the minerals, and the other key essential trace elements, we're not going to be healthy. Folks, this isn't hype. I only bring to my listeners products that I've tried myself and I truly believe in. And the amazing supplements available at InfoWarsTeam.com have certainly delivered my life. I hope you'll give them a try. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
That's the sound of your door being kicked in by an intruder with a single kick. That's the sound of the same door now protected by the Door Sentinel at MySafeDoor.com. Go to MySafeDoor.com right now and watch the amazing video. At MySafeDoor.com, you'll learn how to turn your home into a fortress with the Door Sentinel. 16 kicks later, and the Door Sentinel is still holding strong. MySafeDoor.com. That's MySafeDoor.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
What is the most abundant resource on Earth? Water. It's essential for sustaining life, but it's not always the most available. When disaster strikes, water quickly vanishes from store shelves, like it did during 9/11, Katrina, Japan, and in Joplin. 3 days without water and your body begins to shut down. Don't risk being without an abundant supply of water when the next disaster hits. Get a FlowJack hand well pump. The affordable FlowJack drops right into almost any well and is easy to install without having to remove the existing pump, giving you immediate access to plenty of cool, clean water. You could risk your family's health on a limited supply of stored water, or you could be prepared with the reliable, affordable FlowJack Backup Hand Pump Kit for only $3.99 complete. See how it works at FlowJack.com, spelled FlowJack.com. Be sure to spell FlowJack.com or call 855-4-FLOWJACK, 855-4-FLOWJACK. That's 855-435-6525. Proudly made in America. FlowJack Hand Well Pumps. Peace of mind in a box.
That's what it sounds like when a burglar kicks in the door of a dark house that looks like no one is home. Don't let your home be the next target. Make it look like someone is home watching television with fake TV. Fake TV is a small electronic device that makes the same light as a real television. So from outside, it looks like someone is home watching TV. Fake TV plugs in just like a lamp on a timer, but is far more convincing to burglars. Fake TV deters burglars, costs far less than an alarm, and is highly recommended by numerous police departments. Use it anytime you're away from home. To order your fake TV for only $34.95, go to faketv.com. Or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV. Each additional fake TV is only $29.95. So get one for you and one for a loved one for safety, security, and peace of mind for both of you. Call 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to faketv.com. FakeTV.com, the burglar deterrent.
Roving editor. editor of American Free Press, is our guest, Mark Anderson. If you want to subscribe to the weekly newspaper, one of the only independent newspapers out there, it's 888-699-NEWS, 888-699-NEWS, or you can go to AmericanFreePress.net, and they really care about liberty and freedom because they just share their scoops with Infowars.com every year, and then we share it right back, and it goes up on the Drudge Report and everywhere else. Millions of readers of the stories we write. I mean, we shot videos that got millions of views. Our Justin TV live feeds got 3.5 million views in 2 days. The YouTube got another 2 million. I mean, that's not the radio show. That's Justin TV that we only use when we're on the road because we can't handle the cost on our own servers. 3.5, well, more like almost 4 million. I mean, whoa. And we're going to have reporters there this year. If it's in Europe, if it's in the U.S., you better believe I'm going to be there. I'm not looking forward to the feds, though, always trying to set me up and break into my hotel room and stuff. And David Rockefeller calling me up. People wouldn't. In fact, I didn't even say that. I won't even say stuff on air. It's so bizarre. I tell you, a lot of circuses, isn't it, there when you cover Bilderberg, Mr. Anderson? In the 4 minutes we've got left with you, other points you think are important to make about Bilderberg 2012?
Well, they're at a very pivotal point with NATO. I think the fact that NATO's having a major crisis thing going on, NATO keeps saying, what is our future? Will we just go the way of the Edsel or the way of the Studebaker, or will we have our mission redefined? They're constantly looking in the mirror and putting lipstick on and saying, what is NATO? What is our mission now that the big bad Russians aren't the main thing? And so I think a major thing is going to be to nail down NATO and get it the way they want it. I think they showed a lot of their arbitrary and brutal force in the attack on Libya. And showed what did H.G. Wells call it, the shape of things to come. And I think that that's going to be a huge thing. Jim will probably elaborate on them wanting to create a world treasury department. You know, that's one of their broad, long-range goals.
And they're openly announcing Bank of the World right now. I mean, that's what they want. Yeah, I mean, you're totally vindicated, and so is Jim. Jim, 35, 36 years covering this when they said it didn't exist. It's all out in the open now. What have you found on that front with the fact that everything you've talked about is now admitted?
Well, one of the things is I think you're going to see more American coverage because of it. I haven't found a great deal on that. I think a lot of that's going to become clearer this year in terms of this being a more open thing. Of course, I think European news sources will continue to give it more coverage, even though that coverage is not always favorable. Sometimes the coverage is, yes, there's Bilderberg, but the people protesting about the problem, not the Bilderbergers themselves. That came up in the Swiss and German press last year a little bit. And but NATO's restructuring, NATO wants Germany to pay much more of the bill. They say Germany has the biggest economy and a lot of the real powerhouse of Europe, and yet they're saying Germany isn't spending enough on its military and needs to put more of a footprint monetarily and militarily into NATO. So, in other words, NATO's dictating to what we think should be sovereign nations how big their military should be, how much money they should spend on
it. I mean, the bankers are installing presidents in Greece and Italy now and acting like Germany's taking over. Germany's being sucked dry to fund the creation of the global government that they admit publicly is going to be the euro.
Yeah, they've been trying to suck Germany dry, bailing out Greece, and you know, all these things are the chessmen that the Bilderbergers help move around the chessboard that is their world from their point of view.
Let me ask you this question. They've got to be mad about last year. I mean, you guys and my crew blew them wide open last year.
Yeah, you can still hear the voices echoing through the Alps, including singing David Rockefeller a, 150,000th birthday or however old he is now. And those voices are still probably echoing through the Alps. I remember that as the protesters came down the hill from the Randolins, a hostel there, to the Hotel Silveretta, carrying torches that looked like something out of a Frankenstein movie. It was just absolutely surreal. And sang David Rockefeller a happy birthday to kind of give us a humorous note.
Yeah, it's got the double entendre or the double meaning, like it's friendly, but it's not.
Yeah. Haven't you been here long enough? No offense, but, you know, it's time for you to leave now. It's sort of the, you know, the underbelly.
I think it speaks well for the Swiss that they gave the biggest response to Bilderberg ever of anybody else.
It does. You know, it was awkward to have a group like that in a country known for its storied independence. And that's what Dominique Baitik was trying to say. If you're going to do this, what are you doing it here for?
Look, we're going to have you on graciously. You're very gracious to come on with us as this develops. And from Bilderberg this year, I may be there. Mark Anderson, AmericanFreePress.net, thank you so much for spending time with us.
Okay.
You want to stay over with Jim or you need to go?
I'll give you 5 more minutes.
Okay.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand, eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, we're here live. Back 7 o'clock every night, InfoWars Nightly News. And by the way, tonight we're going to have over an hour of Sheriff Arpaio that you haven't seen or heard. Zolo, his chief investigator, proving it's all fraudulent. Not just that, but other documents Obama has, not just the birth certificate, and more. I'm just going to leave it at that and more. And tomorrow we'll have the big premiere of my analysis of the film Prometheus and how it's basically an Illuminati film. Now, joining us is somebody who I feel like we ought to just salute. Jim Tucker, sports writer, political writer for some of the biggest syndicates in the country, old-fashioned gumshoe, semi-retired now, former editor of American Free Press, still one of the editors there, and who's been shot at in Portugal and laughed at by the national media saying this guy believes there's an imaginary elite group meeting. He's got the only guy who's got real Bilderberg sources. He has predicted, not predicted, he's been proven to have the sources over and over again saying, Bush in 1 month will announce that he's for carbon taxes. No one believed it. Boom, happened. The Berlin Wall will fall in 1 year. Boom, happened. They will fire Margaret Thatcher in 6 months. Boom, happened. Over and over again. They will now lower gas prices from 150 to below 50. Boom, happened. And over again, the intel we get. Last year, they're going to start censoring the internet. They're going to announce their Bank of the World. Boom, that was the agenda. So nobody's got sources like Jim Tucker at AmericanFreePress.net. His biography available at AmericanFreePress.net is absolutely vital. Jim Tucker's Bilderberg Diary. And he joins us here today to give us as much inside scoop on the meeting. Normally, that's in early June. Every 4 years, generally in North America. Will it be in Maryland? Will it be in Virginia? Will it be in the East Coast of Canada? Or will it be in Chicago? We're going to get the latest intel from Jim Tucker with, of course, Mark Anderson, roving editor of AmericanFreePress.net, riding shotgun with us. Jim, good to have you with us.
Oh, it's always fun.
Well, we salute you, my friend. You're the real deal. How does it feel, and then we'll get the latest info, to be totally vindicated in royal flush fashion? Everything you've talked about for 35 years all come true.
Oh, it feels good.
I mean, what was it like talking about the New World Order and being laughed at, and now it's all in the open?
Well, I think I've told you this before, but my experience was... As you said, 30 years with major newspapers and smaller dailies, with wire machines always picking at my ear, and I look at every piece of wire copy, not use it all, the newspaper can, it goes through every piece of it, and not being aware of Bilderberg. So when I came to work for Liberty Lobby, the ancestor of American Free Press in 1975, I was asked what I thought about Bilderberg. And I thought he thought about
Jim, let me interrupt you, which I'm famous for. You're a little too close to your phone. Can you back it off from your mouth a bit? It's a little distorted.
Is this better?
That's better. Go ahead, sir.
All right. So, I was going to file on the very sketchy file at that time on Bilderberg, where late, great Westbrook Tegler had written two columns on Bilderberg, although he did not know they called himself Bilderberg. 1957, off Jekyll Island, North Carolina. He got some telephone tips about the island being sealed off, only limousines and helicopters landing. Helicopters were a brand new thing then. People getting out of big black limousines and going into this building that's guarded by uniformed cops and armed plainclothes type of cops, and not being like Westbrook Tegger, not being like Drew Pearson, Westbrook Tegger actually flew down there to check out the story, and he got his binoculars, and being he found a tall tree. Being a world traveler, he could identify large numbers of international financiers, heads of state from Europe, high officials of our State Department, Department of Defense, high figure from the White House always there to keep the president informed. American president can attend like they do here because every minute of their day is accounted for by the press. So, two heavy columns just raises the questions, why are these distinguished people meeting in private? Why is their secret? Why do they want to make the very meeting itself secret? If I got through with Westbrook Tegger, I was outraged I could be in the business for 30 years and not know who Bilderberg is.
now you forced them to cover it. Let's shift gears here. This is an election year. That's when they were last here 4 years ago. What is your latest intel? Because I know even for mid-level members, they're not told until a few weeks before, so you generally don't learn from your source until 2 weeks before or so. What is the intel you're getting so far, if any, Jim, on where the vaunted meeting is going to take place?
Well, as soon as we find out, we'll put it on our Facebook page. Not wait for the newspaper. Just go to the Facebook page and get it the same day as we know. So far, it's extremely difficult. The sources have been so reliable for the last 15 and 20 years in being able to nail them, because he is a Bilderberg quality. He's an international financier. And he's talked to these people as an individual, as an acquaintance.
Hey, how tapped do you think your phone is?
Certainly it is tapped because I have an unlisted number that's not published for defensive reasons. And people still call me and never been given the number. I've been told this tapped.
Well, you found bugs in your hotel room. You've been shot at. That was Portugal when they shot at you, correct?
Yeah. In fact, I remember when I was checking into a little town with the first being about 40 miles from Atlanta. And, of course, I always take the cheapest room possible. As long as it's a smoking room. Save the company money, and I was all settled in, getting ready to settle in, pulling my other pair of socks out of the drawer, when they came down to me and said, we put you in the wrong room. Your room is 135, not 125, or whatever. So I trotted down there, and after about an hour or so, to newspapers, I rolled back. I had a message to call somebody, but to use a public phone, not my phone. So I called this guy who's been a with the CIA for a lot of years and was now a good friend and champion of exposing Bilderberg. I called him and said, your phone is tapped. So is your chair. You can pull the microphones out of your chair, but leave them on the phone itself so they'll think it's that you're completely bugged. But always remember, when you're on that phone, somebody's listening.
Incredible. Now, we've got Mark Anderson riding shotgun. Pop in any time, Mark. You've got points you want to make. So you have no intel right now on where it's going to be, is what you're saying, Jim?
Yes, and as soon as we do, we'll tell you.
Well, what do you think of them saying it's going to be Haifa over in Israel? Because, I mean, isn't it always every 4 years in North America, or do they ever break with that sometimes?
I've not been able to confirm anything about this Israel thing. I kind of doubt it, but I'm still trying to check it out.
What does your gut tell you? I mean, if they're going to be having G8 summit at Camp David, and they're going to be having NATO in Chicago. I mean, don't they like to be in the U.S. when there's a big election every 4 years?
They don't always pivot to elections because their orders are carried out anyway. They own both horses of a two-horse race. Ever since and after Richard Nixon, their president, after Richard Nixon, has been a member of the Trilateral Commission, the junior varsity, before becoming president or vice president, so in both parties. So they always own, as I said, both horses in a two-horse race.
Sure. Let me raise this point. Mark Anderson, are you still there?
Yeah, I can chime in anytime. I do think that the every 4 years presidential race is a pretty good barometer. And I think that despite all their pseudo-sophistication, these people are somewhat predictable. I'd say it's a high likelihood it'll be in North America this year, although not guaranteed. they trotted out Barack Obama in 08 and, you know, got their imprimatur on him. I believe back in the early 90s, they also trotted out the obscure Arkansas Governor Bill Clinton and said, will he do? Can we put him in the White House? And everybody nodded and said, sure, a little gamey, but we'll go with him and all that. And so, you know, they do have to get somebody lined up for president that will get the nod of these chess players.
Just like Gordon Brown or Tony Blair or any of them, or Von Rumpy of the EU. What about this, Jim? What about this point that a lot of times you know about trilateral commission meetings would have happened or Bilderberg steering? Do you have any intel on the last steering meeting and what is front and center on their agenda right now? Last time you got a snapshot, can you give us that data point? What's on their agenda? You, Jim.
Okay. Their agenda remains a war with Israel, with spending mostly American money and shedding mostly American blood in a backup type of thing. So, leader is a bloody handed threat so we can go to war. But the good news is they are failing miserably as they have for the last several years. They've been trying to get this war going now for well since last Bilderberg meeting. And they're failing miserably because there's a growing public awareness. I've said before, last year Switzerland, we had 1,200 people there. 200 of them were reporters, either broadcast reporters or newspaper reporters, and it drove them wild. And because the American patriots are very good about calling and writing their senators and congressmen, now no senator or congressman dares go for political reasons. He won't say. Well, he'll tell his Bilderberg buddy why he can't go. But the reason he can't go is because of the phone calls he'll get. People say, I'll never vote for you again. And then their elections get closer. We've had a couple of upset elections as a result. The Tea Party is growing strong as a result. And American patriotism.
All right, so people are really waking up. Jim, how long do you think you're going to continue to be able to, you know, cover Bilderberg? Because you've done such an incredible job over the years. I mean, you've said in the past you'll never stop. And I was talking to Mark. He said that you're healthier and got more energy than ever.
Well, I'm doing fine. I just carry this cane along because I'm a freelance song and dance man.
So you're carrying a cane now, huh?
Well, the last 2 years, it has a lot of fringe benefits. When you go into the airport, in the section where they invite cripples in a very short line called they're cripples, they give you a wheelchair, they push you around, you tell them where your gate is, they know exactly where to go, you don't have to go up escalators.
Do you like the TSA groping?
Well, what's that?
You know how the TSA now likes to stick their hands down people's pants. What do you think of that?
I'm not trying with my pants.
So you don't like it, yeah.
Because what expense we should undertake is to get some toilet-trained litter guards at the airport. They pay $8 an hour now, which is below the minimum wage in most states. So they get these illiterate donkeys. And illiterate donkeys are more likely to try to grab a woman, to touch a woman intimately than the normal people.
Well, it's all part of teaching us. You know, the TSA's caught running sex rings, pedophile rings. I mean, what do you expect? Jim, anything else you think that we should know that's really important coming up? Anything you want to impart to the audience? And the same thing to Mr. Anderson.
Well, certainly I want to say do not let up. We have been winning. We should celebrate our victories, but not be so victory turns into defeat. Let's never stop telling the our American politicians and State Department people and other major departments like defense and treasury.
Well, yeah, because exposure is only one part of the equation. We've got to keep exposing and then demand justice. What do you think of Corzine stealing millions and getting away with it publicly?
I'm very unimpressed. I mean, you can be smart, but you can also be criminally smart.
Now, both of you are going to be there this year, regardless if it's in Europe or if it's in Timbuktu or if it's in the United States or Canada. Both of you are going to be there?
It would seem so. You know, of course, that's always predicated on resources providing, you know, provided we have the resources to do so. Like any other news organization, things are kind of lean. But I'll just add, because I've got to cut out here, but I'll just add that Nicholas Burns told a Chicago Council on Global Affairs audience last night that, you know, reconstituting and redefining NATO is a huge thing. And they want to move to the Pacific Rim and Asia and contain China. It's another big thing. And team up with Australia and New Zealand. And a huge thing is the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Absolutely. Well, listen, I want to say bye to both of you off air here in just a moment. But I want to thank Jim Tucker. I want to thank Mark Anderson, AmericanFreePress.net. You can find their Facebook. Mark, on the top of your head, what's the Facebook address for American Free Press?
I actually don't know.
Hey, it's all right. It's linked up on the website, and we'll find out during the break and plug it after the break. Our site's Infowars.com. Let me say bye to both of you right now.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Attention, information in this one-minute message could save your life. Don't wait for the next emergency to happen. Act now to be prepared. Now, more than ever, civilians and communities must communicate with family, friends, and neighbors in the event of civil unrest, natural disasters, or other emergencies. That's why there's CivilDispatch.com. CivilDispatch.com is a universal system that can be used for a wide array of urgent notification alerts. Weather emergencies, civil unrest, emergency responders, amber alerts, school or business closings, any need-to-know situation. CivilDispatch.com is an emergency dispatch communication system, allowing anyone to quickly and easily send and instantaneously track emergency email and text alert notifications. CivilDispatch.com gives you the power of enterprise alerting without the enterprise cost. Don't find yourself unprepared. Learn more and become a member at CivilDispatch.com. That's CivilDispatch.com, civilian emergency dispatch system. Peace through preparedness.
Would it save you time to get the best quality water filters and the best quality storable foods from one company? You bet it would, and now you can at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Big Berkey water filter products and great-tasting, long-lasting, storable, wise foods are both now available on one website, BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Wise foods, ready-to-eat meals are packed in airtight nitrogen pouches and come with a 25-year shelf life. Big Berkey water filters are powerful enough to purify treated, untreated, or even stagnant pond water. Combine Berkey water filters with Wise foods for an unbeatable preparedness combination. Get free shipping on every order over $50. And GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit Big, B-E-R-K-E-Y, waterfilters.com. Or call 877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Or go to BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com.
We'll be right back.
you think I'm broke? I'll be the first in line. You know what I'm sick of? I'm sick of this criminal government, the TSA, all of it. Always trying to make us think we've done something wrong and we're bad and we're evil and we've got something to hide. I mean, here is another article about the TSA running giant prostitution rings. You don't have to be a criminal sexual deviant to work for the TSA, but it helps. Steve Watson, Infowars.com. Prostitution rings, child pornography, trashing hotel rooms, and drunkenly firing guns. A week in the life of TSA agents. Now, I've watched this in Russia. Lenin and Stalin did it. Hitler did it in Germany. Mao did it. They hire people right out of the prisons or street thugs. Because you can't go to the old military or regular esprit de corps of the police and get them to just go into houses and shoot whole families. You always create kind of a street security thug that's federal. And then as the attacks expand, then you start recruiting open criminals in. I mean, who else wants to rip colostomy bags off people and take baby diapers off and scream at people? And again, either folks that really need a job, and that's some of them. It's always like a nice TSA guy. Listen, I don't really want to do this groping. Just can't you go on the scanner? Nope. All right. Let me call Bob over. Bob comes over. That's the person that... So the guy's like, I'm sorry. He just wants a job. But then there's always the supervisor that's, I got kids chained up in the basement at home. Get ready for a proctology exam. I mean, that's basically what it is. And, I mean, it's like every day there's like 20 crimes they're committing, showing that the police and FBI aren't totally corrupt because they are at least busting them. I mean, the most criminal group in law enforcement, because they're not even law enforcement, they're not even sworn, is the TSA. Then it's truancy officers. You can look at the crime statistics. And then it's the ATF. And then it's big city Chicago, New York police, Miami police, I'm going down the list here, Detroit police, Dallas police are pretty darn corrupt at the higher levels. I mean, look at crime statistics. And then you get into the FBI and other people like that. And it is creepy to know they're this criminal. I mean, chances are that person that wants to grope your daughter, and see, I can't fly with my children. I cannot watch my 4-year-old and 7-year-old daughters being grabbed by pedophiles. I mean, I can't handle it. There was one incident I'm not even getting into where it was TSA-style checkpoints on the ground, and nothing ended up happening. So I don't even get into it because they could have really, you know, I could have ended up in some trouble over what, because I just couldn't handle it. And they were so blown away by, you know, the King Kong behavior that they were just like shocked. But I mean, I just listen. This is not an act the way I act on air. This is real. I'm totally freaked out. I want to wake people up, and I want it to stop. 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 You understand? I want it to stop. Not get progressively crazier by the minute. It's like yesterday when I heard the FBI had called one of my IT guys, wanted to talk to him about something. He built websites for like people that own like 9 bars who've been arrested. And I just said, well, you do whatever you want if you're going down there and talk to them. But when they start bringing me up, you know, I'm going to have to talk about it. Sure enough, that's all that went on.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
This is Alex Jones with 5 good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number 1, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number 2, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem.
Number 4. Dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5. A solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCM Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Sick of it. I'm going to try to settle down in this hour after all the news I've read, some of it I've covered on air, the guests I've had on. I just wish people had their basic human instinct to know when everybody's in danger and to know when everybody's under attack. You know, the reason I more and more get into health and vitamin issues and mineral issues and wellness issues is because I've realized myself that's one of the few areas where we can at least partially take charge. That's one of the few areas where we can actually do something. We can filter our water. We can stop eating GMO, at least reduce it a lot. It's hard when you're on the road. We can stop watching as much television and unplug from the Matrix more. And we can buy firearms to protect ourselves, and we can meet like-minded people to develop groups of mutual aid. I don't even call it a militia. Everybody needs mutual aid alliances. Everybody needs a posse, a civil defense. The globalists don't want you to be self-sufficient. And we need to defend the First Amendment and defend liberty. But on the subject of health, I had Rawsome Foods owner, no criminal record, $1 million bail for selling raw milk and papayas at a co-op that was a private club. And I pointed it out. People go to private clubs and drive nails into each other's bodies. People under private agreement can chop each other's arms and legs off. I don't want to get into gross stuff because we have a family audience and people don't really know about this, but amputation is a very popular, trendy thing to do. That all goes on. Under free association, they got swingers clubs, they got everything, but you can't have places where you go buy people's potatoes they grew in their garden. The Soviets and the communists in China are the ones that do that. I mean, we're under Agenda 21 here. And I wanted to get Dr. Corey Gold on because I've had him on a couple times and have been impressed with his research, impressed with his work. And we're going to really introduce him after the break because some stations don't carry this short segment. Most of them do. XM does. Or I think XM does. I know they carry the show, but I never have time to listen to my own show because it's live. Kind of be hard to do. I've got all these things we could talk about in today. We only got about a minute and a half. We're going to break. But what are some of the topics, Dr. Gold, you want to bring up today? I know I've got a laundry list.
Well, hey, Alex, good to talk to you. I mean, right along with what you were talking about, we have a story out of England where a think tank has come up with the conclusion that not only is abortion a great thing, but people, once they're born, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months old,
3 years,
they don't have a right to life. They don't have a right to life. That just because you're born doesn't even entitle you to keep living.
And it's done out in the open.
Oh, no, they're publishing their paper. They're proud of it. It's intellectual thought. The brightest minds are back to where Nazi Germany was, that just because you're born, just because you're 6 months old, you still don't have a right to life, even though you've been born and are breathing.
And by the way, that is how it started in Nazi Germany, was medical tyranny, for those that don't know.
No, you're right. And now they're talking more about what things you can and can't put into your body. Pharmaceuticals are terrific, but hey, wait a second. You know, you don't get to know what's GMO. Why would they not tell us what foods contain GMO? Isn't it in our best interest to know and make decisions?
Yeah, let's talk about that, because for those that don't know, they're moving to where you can't know if it's GMO, and they want to restrict vitamins and minerals. Dr. Corey Goldie's a dentist, and a lot more coming up, one of the leading experts out there. We're going to talk about ways to counteract the globalist on the other side, and probably also open the phones up for questions about vitamins and minerals or health issues, vaccines, with Dr. Corey Gold straight ahead. And, of course, he's involved with InfoWarsTeam.com as well. Stay with us. We'll be back. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right. Dr. Corey Gold is one of the most respected nutritionists and health product developers in the country. I mean, he's big time. And, you know, has produced some of the best-selling products that are out there. So he's well known. He speaks all over the world to groups of hundreds and thousands of people. He, of course, received his doctorate in dental surgery. He's a dentist from the University of California, San Francisco. However, prior to that, he received a bachelor degree in biology with a minor in chemistry from California State University, Fullerton, and received a bachelor's degree in dental sciences from the University of California, San Francisco. And, of course, he's also a talk show host, radio talk show host, a popular talk show host. And now he spends his free time participating in running marathons, triathlons. He and his wife are very active in supporting children and families struggling with autism and spectrum disorders. So I want to cover the waterfront with him because, as I said in the last segment, one of the areas where we can actually take control of our lives to a great extent, there's the aluminum dioxide, chemtrailing and barium and all that. There's the electromagnetic stuff they're doing to us. And every week, somebody's girlfriend in the office or one of their friends who's like 35, 25, 40 gets cancer. I mean, I look at the numbers, 2,000+% for adults increase on average in the last 40, 50 years. You look at the numbers. And some child cancers are up over 10,000 percentage points. I mean, it's a devastation. And they're doing it to us. I got all the Rockefeller Foundation documents. Every day we're posting more articles with just all the admissions, how they're doing it to us. I mean, just total evil out in the open, jacking the food, the water. They're now in prestigious medical journals saying kill babies up to age 3. Bill Gates comes out and says, kill grandma. He says, don't give grandma care. We can hire 10 teachers. The teachers clap. He says death panels. I've played the clip like 50 times. If you're a new listener, don't say, oh, that's not true. Just like a month ago, Paul Watson first saw the big prestigious journal of bioethics. They don't have the Hippocratic Oath anymore. They just, the bioethicists say what we do. And I've had Wall Street Journal writers on where for decades they've already been killing people who are wards of the state who are healthy. They just chain you down and kill you. This is already going on is the point. But people emailed me and said, this isn't true. No, Watson had links to it. They're not saying kill babies. This got to be a joke. And then once it was in the mainstream news, picked up from us, it was like, wow, that's, well, maybe it's needed. First, it's, oh, kill them up to the birth. Well, China kills them after they're born. Maybe that's reasonable. How about to age 3? So you were getting into that in the short little segment, Dr. Gold. And then I want to get into how they don't want us to know if stuff's GMO, the attacks on the Amish. I mean, this is crazy. Even for me, they're moving fast. And if they're moving this fast, what are they getting us ready for? Dr. Corey Gold, break it down.
It seems like everything's turning into a cost-benefit analysis as opposed to do no harm. It's, well, who's got value? And they're putting value on human life. We've seen this happen before in Nazi Germany when they said, oh, gypsies don't have value, homosexuals don't have values, Jews don't have values, therefore they don't have right to life. In fact, it'd be better for society if they just were disappearing and, just pretend those places don't exist. We're making the world a better place. We got away from that, and here we are again, where first we got into abortion being considered to be a healthy thing and a societal positive thing. They tell you that you are narrow-minded and don't like society if you think abortion's bad. Now these great think tanks of these people who consider themselves to be quite elite are telling us that, well, newborns, do they really have a right to life? Does someone get born with a right to life? And if they're so young and they can't take care of themselves, would it be okay and moral to kill them? And then it's a very small leap to, well, old people can... they take care of themselves. Is there a cost benefit of what are they providing? Are they still providing positive things for society? Does somebody actually have a heart and soul in this whole matter? The answer is no. It's turned into an elitist who has a right, who has value.
Continue.
And you can take this a lot farther because eventually, if a lie is told long enough, eventually it becomes truth. We've heard this over and over again. So we people in China accept one child policy is a normal societal thing. And if you are a loyal member of the Communist Party in China, you don't question what you're hearing in China, that one child is the right way to go. We've had politicians here, even, was it Joe Biden, I believe, I could be wrong, but I think it's Joe Biden who said, well, the one child policy, it's right for China. It's not a bad thing. He didn't criticize it. You know, that's what I would do. It's like, what, are you kidding me? You're going to tell people they can only have one child. You're going to, make infanticide okay. Well, it's okay for them. How is murder okay for a huge
country? And so now that we accept that, okay, we're going to kill your babies here. In fact, it's admitted. I mean, I remember 10 years ago talking about China selling political dissidents' organs. It was admitted. China advertised it. It was in European news, the mobile execution vans, and naive Americans living in their bubble would call me and say I was a liar because the internet wasn't as ubiquitous, so most of them wouldn't go check it. Now it's known, Dr. Gold, as you are pointing out, and China admits they go and find people hiding already born babies and put them in a bucket of water. And Planned Parenthood supporters are defending that. And there's the tapes where you can call up Planned Parenthood and say, I want to give money to kill black babies. And I'm like, give us the money. I got Margaret Sanger photos with the Klan saying kill blacks, but she's held by liberals. These high-level liberals are not liberals. They are eugenicists. The real racist Do not, the real evil control freaks, it's beyond racism, don't come out and wear a Klan uniform. They pose as a liberal. Can you speak to that?
Well, yeah. In fact, I have a couple people who I consider to be friends. They went to the best schools. And if you talk about the value of human life, they look at you like you're crazy. Because where they went to school, they were taught to think that, first off, if you believe in God, you've got to be a crazy person to believe of a smiling face in the sky who knows what you think and you're naughty or nice. It's a fairy tale. So those people who put trust into God and think of themselves as being God-fearing and whatever religion they follow, they think of those people as being feeble-minded. And that it is really people who put value on things, and we as a society should decide what has value and not have value, and no one has any innate human rights to life, liberty, or the things that were the founding values of our country. And yet they'll look at you and say, you know, poor Corey, he's just so naive to think that there's a God and to think that he has, you know, value before God and to think that people have a right to life. You know, that's such a naive, old, you know, kind of like, you know, thinking of like Mayan temple way of thinking. You're still in the old thought. And they think that people who might have a gun, of course, you must be a mass murderer. And if somebody has a Bible, they must be narrow-minded and must be very not too smart. Because in their world, if you have those belief systems of being independent, of being self-determining, of taking care of you and your family, of, you know, being entrepreneurial.
You're not a collectivist. You're a threat.
No, you're not a team player. You're not a team player. A team player says what's best for the collective, not what is right.
Well, expanding on that, reading into deeper globalist documents, they are spiritual at the top. They believe they're basically God, and they want to control this planet, and they don't want other people saying, no, I have a right to determine my own future. So I want to say something to atheists. If you want to be an atheist or an agnostic, that's your issue. I get it that mainline religion's a joke, glitter bugs on TV begging for money. I get all that. But what I'm saying to them is the collectivist globalist advertise themselves as humanists, but they're not really trying to empower humanity. Through the eugenics, they're actually going after people that they see as the uncontrolled mavericks, and they want the state to be God, and that's why they don't want you individually to be able to determine what you believe and what's valuable to you. They want you to say, do what we say. So it's not even the community's going to determine, you know, what we say is valuable. They're going to say it. Well, they've already said we're crud. Well, I'm here to tell them I'm not crud. And somebody that doesn't appreciate life, and somebody that doesn't understand you've got to protect the weak, and somebody that doesn't have those instincts, they're the ones that are screwed up. And I declare war on them, doctor.
Well, and you think about it, you know, now we're talking, I was listening to the Supreme Court arguments for the health mandate, that the government can mandate you to buy something. And I heard Justice Scalia say, well, what's next? They're going to mandate you buy broccoli. And, you know, people laughed. And I heard commentators going, well, why couldn't the government mandate you buy broccoli? It's good for you. So in that vein, if this goes through, what can't the government tell you to do if they think it's good for you? Can they tell you where to live? Can they tell you what job to have?
And MSNBC, I just saw him during a break, we have it on back there, was saying, yeah, we do need the government to tell us what to do.
Right. You know, we can tell you what job you'd be best at. We can tell you where you might want to live. Right now, the government's, you know, giving most people loans. They give most people health. They give most people, education. They give most people food. When you're beholden to the government for food, housing, education, and your job, are you really free?
And even if you're, quote, independent and have your own farm, if you don't pay that property tax, they're going to take it. You're paying a rent. We didn't have property tax until 60 years ago. Again, we had real freedom before. You know, they've gotten rid of some injustices, but brought in a whole nother set of them.
Yeah, and they assume if you're not for universal health care that you want people to die in the streets, but just the opposite. People weren't dying on the streets. I mean, there were religious-run hospitals. There were charitable foundations taking care of people in their local community. People were being taken care of by people in their own area.
When you were in dental school, they told you you had to do, 30% of your stuff for free. My dad was taught the same thing. That's why he does it. Now others don't do it, so he gets a line around the block of folks. It's incredible. Go ahead.
Well, most people want to help other people if they're able to. And that includes doctors and dentists and, you know, people who own restaurants. And most people do the right things. Most people have a conscience and try to do the right things within the best of their ability. But when the government takes on all the roles, it's telling you, you know, Corey, Alex, you don't have to be that guy to help other people. You don't even have to be the person to take care of yourself or your children. The government will take care of all those
and
things.
And now
you
you'll stand by as your neighbors drug away or as people are facing 40 years in prison for selling healthy, fresh milk.
Or worse, look what happened in Nazi Germany. People were literally taken away. Neighbors they had known for 20 years, they were taken away because it was considered to be good for the state. I'm even going to criticize America. We took Japanese Americans and put them in internment camps.
And took their property. And took their property.
Yeah, we took all their stuff and we thought it was good for America. Long live liberty.
Unbelievable. I want to come back and get your take on the NDAA. I mean, they're actually the head of the FBI goes, yeah, I guess we can disappear people forever. I mean, right there. I mean, that is off the charts. He's like, I got to check with the White House, but that is what the law says. You're going to have a law I can disappear?
I'd seen the longevity products work for many others. And so I bought a bunch of them, started using them, had a little bit of results, but I wasn't following the regimen every day. But Aaron Dykes in my office did and lost more than 60 pounds. When I saw those results, I said, I better follow my own advice. I started taking the longevity products and it's been incredible. 37 pounds in 2 months. Our bodies are amazing, and God gave us an incredible gift. But if our body doesn't have the tools it needs, all of the vitamins, all of the minerals, and the other key essential trace elements, we're not going to be healthy. Folks, this isn't hype. I only bring to my listeners products that I've tried myself and I truly believe in. And the amazing supplements available at InfoWarsTeam.com have certainly delivered my life. I hope you'll give them a try. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com. There are limitless ways to go into business for yourself, but most involve substantial capital and risk. Our InfoWarsTeam.com operation is different. We promote premium quality health, energy, and skincare products using dynamic, caring personalities and state-of-the-art media technology to spread a powerful message of health, wealth, longevity, and freedom. This low-cost business opportunity is designed for full-time or part-time, so you can work as little or as much as you'd like. It is you that defines the reward level. Whether you are seeking a few hundred extra dollars per month or a six or even seven figure annual income, it's up to you. Want to find out more? Shoot an email with InfoWars Team in the subject line to InfoWars Team Coordinator MZ and tell him a little bit about yourself. That's the initials MZ at InfoWarsTeam.com. That's MZ at InfoWarsTeam.com. I only promote products that I truly believe in, and these are phenomenal. Whatever you do, visit InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hey there, you've reached Claire. Leave me a message.
Claire, it's Anne. Hey, you know that hormone balancing product we talked about before? The all-natural one. Ambrin? Well, I gotta tell you this. Not only did Ambrin stop my hot flashes, but since I started the Ambrin program, I have lost so much weight. Seriously, even my belly fat, it's gone. I haven't been this thin in years. I feel great. Give me a call.
The leading cause of weight gain in women over 40 is hormonal imbalance. Until you balance your hormones, it can be practically impossible to lose weight. Ambrin restores hormonal balance naturally, so the weight can just fall off. Yes, even that stubborn belly fat. Plus, Ambrin eliminates other symptoms of hormonal aging too. So with your hormones in balance, you can feel great and finally lose the weight. Be one of the first 50 callers right now, and they'll send you a complimentary risk-free trial with a 30-day supply, free. Call 1-800-408-1130. That's 1-800-408-1130. 1-800-408-1130.
We all know the importance of having storable foods, but what about when the food runs out? What then? For real food independence, you need a supply of non-hybrid seeds. Introducing the Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com. The Survival Seed Vault is sealed for freshness and includes 20 varieties of easy-to-grow non-hybrid seeds for only $37.95. For less than $40, you've got real food independence. And the Survival Seed Vault includes detailed planting and seed-saving instructions. Imagine the barter power you'll have when the food supply does collapse. Right now, save $9 instantly when you buy three or more survival seed vaults from MyPatriotSupply.com. Same day shipping on all orders, plus free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Or discover more emergency preparedness products at MyPatriotSupply.com. That's MyPatriotSupply.com.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, appeasing this tyranny will not abate the evil we face. Only going head up against the tyrants gives us any chance or future as a society. I beg of you to count the cost and join those that love the Republic.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance.
Reality is so much more real than the artificial system they put out on the television and in the entertainment system. That's a false reality pulled up over your eyes to blind you from the truth. Dr. Corey Gold is our guest. I want to get back into health issues in ways we can from your research. I mean, you're a triathlete, whole nine yards. You've seen amazing things as a dentist that the medical system won't tell the people that they know. Most doctors are ignorant, but the higher-ups know. But the whole NDAA thing, I mean, I see Americans buying 5 million guns a month. The previous record was something like 1.5 million. In questionnaires, they say they think the government's evil and that there's going to be a collapse. And I don't like go, ooh, they're buying guns. Wonderful. We'll have some big war. It'll be like a movie. No, no. The globalists actually may want this civil war. But I'm not having anybody take my kids anywhere. I'm not taking inoculations. And again, I'm somebody on the air to 50 million people making real statements here. And it's sick that I've had to get to the point where everything I thought was going to happen has been confirmed in spades. And it's one thing to know it intellectually. Now it's manifesting. You talk about Nazi Germany or Soviet Russia. I mean, we're following exactly, and it's so creepy. Dr. Gold, I mean, what do you do whenever you see them saying shut down vitamin mineral companies, arrest people, disappear people, and using the drug war apparatus and racketeering against vitamin and mineral people and arresting Amish and trying to put them in jail for 40 years? I mean, this is savage criminals.
Yeah, it was interesting. Last night I was watching the Supreme Court testimony yet again, and one of the justices says, doesn't it say that at the discretion of the secretary that they could do all these horrible things? And then the other guy said, yeah, but it's at the discretion. We're not really going to do it. But they have the ability to do it. It's written into the laws. They have the ability at their discretion
to
do
certain
things.
They said that on the Patriot Act. Obama says, right. NDAA, I won't do right. it. Now they're starting.
Right. And then so the other justice says, well, if they do it, then, of course, you can relitigate it. Meanwhile, what's happened in between? And, so now we have to relitigate. So they write in powers into laws that, of course, we'll never use these powers. So one of the other justices says, well, why don't you just remove it? He says, well, I don't want to say we'll never use it.
Oh.
So there you go. So if you have something in your bill that says at your discretion, you can do horrible things.
They're snakes.
There's a reason it's there. There's a reason it's there. And now you're talking about people disappearing because for your good, Alex, and my good, certain people might be horrible. They haven't been charged with being horrible, and all of a sudden they disappear, and there's no time frame for them to have to be charged.
All right, well, let's use some number, and I want your take on this, but I've studied World War II in depth. I kind of got into it when I was a teenager, and then in college probably read over 100 books just on the European theater and the SS and the rest of it because it was so interesting historically. I read the declassified British wartime reports, the mind of Adolf Hitler, all of it. I read Mein Kampf. I really wanted to understand it and then moved on. I've always been a big history person. I want people to know, around 15% or so of the Gestapo they'd send out to grab people, even though Europeans were pretty submissive compared to Americans on average, never came back, okay? And this is not going to be like Russia where, almost no one resisted the NKVD. Do they think they're going to start all this and not end up like Swiss cheese? I mean, do they really think they're just going to start arresting people and disappearing them? And then the next person is going to know that they... I mean, that's going to create an escalation with law enforcement that is going to be horrific. Does the system realize what they're being put into, Dr. Gold?
I don't think the system does, and a lot of it's incrementalism, which is, okay, well, we got away with this, so we'll do a little bit more. But we'll do it in an extreme case where you go, well, that was a really bad guy. Therefore, I can understand why you grabbed that really bad guy. Well, we can kill Americans who are in other countries without even search warrant or giving them any, you know, papers or anything, because they were real bad guys. They were terrorists. We sent drones over to kill them. They asked the government, could we do that in America? If we thought we had a real bad guy in America, could we just off him without thinking, well, yeah, it's possible we could do that here in America, but only with really, really, really bad, terrible people. Well, now we have incrementalism. Now the government can kill somebody without warrant here in the United States. What comes next? Everything's incrementalism. Well, you accept that. What's next?
Look, I mean, they're opening Pandora's box, and the bankers are going to sit offshore and laugh at all this. Everybody's having to think now, okay? They'll say they'll disappear us. And the guns are all being sold off the shelves. I mean, look, New World Order, you're not doing this in the dark. Everybody knows what you're doing. And if you strike me down, everybody knows what you're doing. We'll be right back with Dr. Gold. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even if I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com. Or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lung system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs Generator. Not only does the Silver Lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung system at www.silverlungs.com. to learn more about how the Silver Lung system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
As I tell you many times every month, don't take the internet and the freedom that's left there for granted. use it or lose it. You keep it free by using it, but you also use it like you're not going to have it in the future. You got that? It's kind of like Mama spent 2 hours making you the best biscuits and dumplings. It takes hours to make. You better eat it when it comes out hot, because dumplings aren't that good warm back up later. Not good ones. Same thing with fried chicken. And to use the food analogy here, it's a nightmare. And, you know, my wife sits there and says to me, she says, you know, people were the same way in Germany and the same way in Russia. They kept saying, oh, we'll beat it. And, you know, our family's here and everything's here. And she's like, I'm not saying we should leave, but we should look at it. And I've actually said, well, whatever happens, we're just staying here, because I just can't give in to the fear. But I understand her as a woman. In a way, you do win if you get away. I mean, I just can't believe the American people. Sure, they're buying 5 million guns a month and saying it's for the government, but, I mean, why? Why do we have to have the government say they're going to, because that's government-backed bioethics group, they're going to kill 3-year-olds that are even healthy? They've skipped, oh, let's just kill people that aren't healthy. We're going to kill babies. And I get the government training manuals, and it's all about how they're calling sovereign citizens people that have gardens now and people that are into minerals and vitamins. That's an extremist group now. That's what they were telling the Rawsome Foods guy. Like, you're anti-government. And he's like, well, I'm kind of like a liberal. I'm not in it. I just want to have a food co-op. $1 million bail. It's good people are the enemy. Have you figured that out yet? I want to get into some solutions, because one area we can fight back is taking care of our bodies. And there are powerful tools out there while you can still use them. Dr. Corey Gold, from your deep research and the amazing results you've gotten and all the products you developed, run down the main things people can do immediately, whether it's moderate exercise, deep breathing, vitamin C, what can cleanse you. I mean, you know, the top 10 things. You've got the floor. We'll go ahead and fade them up.
You mentioned a few.
Go ahead.
Well, you... Okay, we're back, I think. Well, you mentioned a few right there. First off, you talked about water earlier in the show. The more water, you know, a lot of the things that people put in their body, even if they taste good, are bad for them. So I you have a cola now and then, but the more clean, pure water you can drink, the better. And people have been told they don't need to drink much. Actually, they need to drink quite a bit. So a lot of water in your body, flush toxins out of your
system. How much? Give me a number. Give me a number.
Oh, my gosh. I would take 4 to 5 water bottles, eight ounce water bottles a day, at least 40 ounces of water a day, if not more. And it sounds like a lot for people who've never done it, but it's just replacing.
Since I started taking your advice, because it's so important, I drink like 2 or 3 glasses. And I guess once you're dehydrated, your body isn't thirsty. Once you start drinking water, it was like being a kid again in football practice when I really enjoyed it. Now I'm just guzzling it and want more and more.
Well, what happens is that when your body doesn't have water, it tends to retain the water, but your water's got to flush through your system. It's designed to move things through your system. So if you're not giving your body enough water, it retains it in a certain way. It doesn't go through a normal channels. So you need to actually have more water. Lots of water, be pure water. Don't, you know, I'm not a big fan of tap water, so have your water purified, get all the toxins out. Some water districts put things into the water for whatever reason. They say it's good for you. I'm a believer that if I want it in my body, I'll add it myself. So I like pure clean water, and I like lots of it. And once your body gets used to it, you're right, it craves it. It doesn't crave it now because it's taking colas and other things that are replacements of that your body thinks are better than. It's not. Water's far better, and the more you have, the more you'll want it. Another thing your body can do is have organic, you know, clean, raw vegetables, and the closer grown to you, the better. So you talk about people growing their own vegetables, that's the best. You know, you're picking it, you're eating it right away, you know it's been taken care of correctly, it hasn't lost all its minerals. Most of the food that you're getting in the stores has been shipped in from sometimes thousands of miles away, sometimes boated over from South America. A lot of hormones and other things have been put into
fluoride's been sprayed on it as a pesticide. The list goes on and on. It's been radiated in many cases.
Yeah. In a lot of cases, it's by the time it gets to you, it just doesn't have, it may have the right color, and sometimes it's even put under colored light so it looks better in the store. But when you get it home, you're just eating kind of empty calories, and you're wondering, why am I so hungry? A lot of people in the United States are obese, but they're eating an awful lot. And one of the reasons they're eating an awful lot is they're still starving. So they're heavy people who are starving for nutrition because the food they're eating is devoid of nutrition. And if you think of these dollar menus, and it's not that I've never gone through one, I have, but the things they put on the dollar menus because people don't have a lot of money are things basically devoid of nutrition but having a lot of calories. So they're eating all these starches and they're gaining all this weight. They're putting on adipose and fat, but they're not gaining nutrition. So they're becoming osteoporotic. They're having trouble thinking. They can't have energy. They're becoming lethargic. They want to become couch potatoes because the food they're eating. So you've got to be eating high nutrient foods. And you've got to be getting rid of all those fake carbohydrates that people are eating. So those are two or three of the things you can do. I'm a big believer in supplementation, and I believe that we're not getting all the foods from our diets, even if we're doing our very best. So I take a broad spectrum of nutrition. That's why we put together the Alex Pack is one of the things we present on InfoWarsTeam.com, because it has the vitamins, it has the trace minerals, it has the omega oils, it has the calcium, magnesium, it has the whole host of things that people need, because your body just doesn't need two or three nutrients. Because you get things that says, this has extra calcium. Extra calcium is great. But without magnesium, it's not going to work very well. And with vitamin D, it even works better. The whole body works better when it's getting a complete spectrum of trace minerals. Your body wasn't designed just to run on one or two nutrients. It was designed to have a whole chemistry set put in each day.
Now, expanding on that, I always like some vegetables that were cooked. I like salads, things right. like that. But now, not that I'm in great shape, but I've lost right at 40 pounds now in just the last 4 or 5 months. Now that I started making myself eat big salads and making myself just eat, a whole raw green pepper. Now that I make myself get into eating carrots and things, now I'm beginning to crave it. So back when I, was eating mainline cruddy food and like 10 years ago, even fast food and stuff, I would want that because it had chemicals and things into it that my brain was tuned to. But now that I'm slowly segued away from all that, it's accelerating. So people think, oh, I'm in such horrible shape. Oh, it's so bad. I'll never dig out of this hole. That's not what I'm finding. It's like once you train yourself back to what's good, and it's a battle, but it gets easier the more you do. So how do you recommend people start that journey?
Well, it's first off, I don't expect people to make huge changes all at once. I expect people to make segmented changes, bite-sized steps. I add drink more water is a great first step. Carry a water bottle of water with you everywhere you go, and every time you have an urge to drink a soda or something that's carbonated or something that's looks like it's sweetened, just drink water instead. Your body will start loving water. You started talking about eating salads. If you start chew your food more, it'll actually taste better. Those vegetables have
my dad always told me that. He'd say chew your food, chew that green beans, chew that squash. That's when I would always want sugar on my cereal, and as a child he'd make me chew it and we'd get sweet, and I was like, oh. And now I've shown my kids that, but it just, we're never taught any of this common sense.
Right. And for people, most people are deficient in omega oils. They're called EFAs, essential fatty acids. The vast majority of people are deficient in EFAs. So their body seeks French fries. Their body seeks pizza. Their body seeks other things that have that oils in them that have been fried, because it needs the oils. It needs the EFAs. It's seeking the wrong thing. So if you get your body some EFAs, it will not want those things anymore. In fact, sometimes now I look at commercials for fast food and I actually go, ooh, I can tell you when I was 20, I go, wow, look at that. Those nachos look fantastic. Nowadays, I'm like going, oh, that makes me sick to even look at them, because my body's getting the omega oil, so it's not looking for that. And that's one of the reasons that's part of the Alex Pack, is we put the omega oils in. And what's funny is that people don't understand there's things called trace minerals. They come from plants. And your body was designed to get all these trace minerals, but now in most of the foods you're eating, or a lot of the foods you're eating, they're not there anymore, because the soils are just so denuded. They've been so, I hate to use the word, but raped draped over. They haven't been good soil management, and there's been pesticides sprayed into everything.
Yeah, they're not fallow. They put the pesticide that kills the microbes. This is mainline science. They've known this for 50 years and really been worried about it. So then they use chemicals and fertilizers that are designed to grow in dead soils, so it's not even what the plants are really supposed to even look like or taste like. It's a specially engineered garbage.
Well, when you think of the concept of GMOs, genetically modified organisms, they're designed to be immune to all these things that you have to have something crazy going on to be immune from bugs eating them or bugs dying when they eat them. So I'm kind of concerned personally about putting GMOs into my system, and I'm pretty upset with my government for making it unavailable for me to know what foods have GMOs. You know,
tell folks about that. And we've had lawsuits where big organic milk companies, you know, I mean, the ones that are homogenizing and boiling it and all that, you know, in the grocery store, they've been sued by Monsanto and others because they don't want them putting a sign on it saying we don't have hormone or GMO. I mean, they're suing not just government, but private groups don't want you to know what you're getting.
And you have to ask why, because you figure if somebody just says without GMOs, what harm would that be? Somebody could go into a store and say, oh, that doesn't have GMOs. That does have GMOs. This one's not even saying it's bad for you. It's just saying it doesn't have it. And they don't want you to know that because innately you would say genetically modified. I'd rather have the non-genetically modified thing, please. So how can they sell you something if you would prefer the other? It's cheaper for them to make it GMO, and they can call patents on the things that we eat every day will now be patented. Is that a patented potato? Is that a patented strawberry? Did you pay your toll tax on that patented thing? It's amazing to think that they want to patent what we're currently eating and people were eating, you know, 2,000, 3,000 years ago. They're not going to patent them because they somehow genetically modified
and
them.
Infect your stuff as they've done with canola and then sue you and admit in court they infected you, but it's still a patent infringement that 1% of the genetics of your canola or your soybean is theirs. And then that's the same thing with vitamins, doctor. Tell them how they're openly now patenting a manipulated vitamin C or manipulated fish oil, then trying to block you getting the $5 bottle and trying to make you buy a $200 bottle.
Well, it's an old saying called follow the money. There are now these prescription omega oils. You know, I remember my father would tell me his mother would give him cod liver oil or give him like anchovies. And I go, oh, how gross. She was giving him omega oils. That's where they come from. That's omega-3s. That's where they come from. So nowadays we have omega oil, you know, capsules. They're terrific. They're molecularly screened to have bad things out of them. You're just getting the omega-3s, and people can take them without having to have the fish taste. And now they're saying, wait a second, we're not sure you should have those. We now have a pharmaceutical version that costs, $50, $100 a month when there's a $10, $20 version that really works really well and has never hurt anybody to my knowledge. And it gives great service to people. So follow the money trails when the pharmaceutical companies get involved.
Exactly. And if they can ban raw milk and papayas, they can ban anything. I mean, even Forbes asked, why is there a war against lemonade stands? Because they don't want any mom and pops. It's that simple. This is a corporatocracy global government.
Yeah, and you know, so I'm a big believer in getting what I can into my body to help my body work. My body was created, and it has a wonderful self-correction mechanism that I don't understand, and doctors are just basically scratching the surface of understanding. But when it's given the right nutrition, it can do pretty marvelous things to fix itself. It's not completely perfect, but it can do amazing things. So you want to feed it and give it the ingredients it needs to do its job the right way. And those are the vitamins and the minerals and the omega oils and the basic things that come from plant-derived sources, like we put into the Alex pack, that we put it all together like a bow around it, the basic, unique, basic starting points.
I'm just here marveling at what you're saying, Doc. Expanding on all of this, this is a win-win-win. Sure. I have shown people, they've seen me lose right at 40 pounds. They've seen Aaron lose almost 90. He kept saying 80, and I said, how much is it really? And he goes, well, it's embarrassing, but a couple pounds short of 90. He's a new person. And he was literally leaving work every day. I told him if he wanted to, go ahead. I was for his health. He was going to personal trainers. He was trying to walk and jog. He was torturing himself not eating. And then Ted Anderson got on Youngevity. I got right. some. He started taking it. He heard Ben Fuchs. Now he, you know, had heard you. He got into it. He did it. And he's like, this is like magic. And he really has done it more than I have. I mean, I've just started taking the Tangy Tangerine, a little bit of the EFAs, stuff like Rebound Pollen Burst. But he went whole hog on longevity. And I'm about to do it. It's just I'm so untrained to be doing this. I mean, I'm used to just eating. But I do eat about half of what I ate. I've lost 40 pounds. He's lost almost 90. And it's like magic. And yeah, it's a business. We support ourselves. I'm risking my life here to bring you this information. I want to build a news organization. So yeah, I'm selling vitamins and minerals. But I went out and found stuff that is the best out there. InfoWarsTeam.com. You can also sign up for $10 and get discounts and become a distributor. Again, InfoWarsTeam.com. There's a phone number there. There's weekly training, phone calls. It's all there. But bottom line, just try the Tangy Tangerine. Just try things like that because it's amazing how depleted we are. And these synthetic minerals that just go through us, this is the real natural minerals. InfoWarsTeam.com. But it isn't hype. I mean, my mother has lost a ton of weight. It's not even advertised as weight loss. She's a triathlete. She says, my gosh, I was already taking vitamins and stuff. Why is this? She's asking, why is Tangy Tangerine, just the one thing she's taking, that and now essential fatty acids, why is that having such an incredible effect on her with her running, her swimming, all of it?
Well, she's already in great shape, so she's already done a lot of good things, and this, her body can quickly respond and get better. Think of your body as a chemistry set. If you're missing a couple test tubes, it can only do so much. You give it a couple of things that your body's been deficient in, and all of a sudden it starts popping on all cylinders. It's like fine-tuning a car. So all of a sudden your mom, who's been doing a lot of good things, now gets those few things she's been missing, and boom, she's like firing on all pistons, and away she goes. A guy like Aaron Dykes, once his system starts working the way it used to work, remember how we used to feel when we were 13, 14, 15? I would run around the yard like all day long and come in like only when it got dark. I would never get tired. We just run around and play all day.
Exactly. From sun up to sundown like crazed heathen.
Yeah, it's like I would just go out in the front yard and play. We didn't have, you know, set rules. We just ran around and played because our bodies just had all those natural chemicals running in them that let us go play and have fun. And also our parents, you know, they gave us good food. Our food was grown locally.
My grandmother made them take the cod liver spoonfuls.
You got it.
Mama knew best.
They did. A lot of this wisdom that we got from our ancestors was not silly. A lot of the things that we now look back at and saying, where'd that come from? It comes from good sound advice. Eating your cod liver oil, we eat EFAs instead, but it's the right thing to do.
Amazing. InfoWarsTeam.com. There's also a phone number on there, but I guess for people that aren't online, that doesn't help them. I always forget the number. We'll look it up and have it for you after the break and talk more about things you can do. But the big thing, you don't need to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and get Tangy Tangerine. The big thing is start drinking water, start exercising, stop eating GMO aspartame.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Healthy soils grow healthy plants. So before you plant your survival garden this year, is your soil healthy? Maximize your crisis garden soil with EM1 from Terraganics. EM1 organic soil conditioner, fertilizer amendment, and compost accelerant provides healthier gardens and faster, efficient garden composting. EM1 from Terraganics.com quickly improves soil structure by increasing nutrient availability and converting organic matter into soil humus. This improves seed germination and root growth, improves plant quality, size, color, flavor, nutrient value of fruits and vegetables, and improves shelf life. And when rain is not in the forecast, no worries. EM1 improves moisture retention in soils, helping reduce drought stress. Just like you prepare all else, prepare your crisis garden for maximum yields with EM1 from Terraganics.com. Order now at TERAGANIX.com or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Terraganix, life's getting better.
Don't answer it.
If fear strikes your heart when the phone rings, knowing it may be another bill collector, it's time for you to call Zero Debt in 90 Days. 800-477-9256. Settlements, bankruptcy, and attorneys are not the answer and may end up costing you up to 10 times more than necessary. Listen, if you're already in debt, does it make sense to get buried in another payment plan? Zero Debt in 90 Days gets you out of debt in 90 days guaranteed without a payment plan and without attorneys or going to court. Get the fastest relief from debt on the planet when you call 800-477-9256. If you have debt with the IRS, credit cards, student loans, or a foreclosure, we can help at Zero Debt in 90 Days, and we are the only organization to provide written guarantees on the results. Go to ZeroDebtGuaranteed.com. That's ZeroDebtGuaranteed.com. Or call now for free information. 800-477-9256. That's 800-477-9256.
We got a big InfoWars Nightly News tonight. Going to have the Arpaio interview with the chief investigator with all the fraud that Obama's engaged in. Send a team out there. It's like over an hour of stuff you haven't seen on the Nightly News tonight and more. A couple program notes here. Well, if you're interested in joining the InfoWars team, InfoWarsTeam.com, you can go to InfoWarsTeam.com or call 877-551-1301 if you've got any questions or comments or want to order over the phone, 877-551-1301. And again, you can sign up and be a distributor and get discounts and wholesale prices or just get it off the site, 877. Again, we'll put it back up there on screen, 877-551-1301 or InfoWarsTeam.com. And lastly, I'm going to go back with final comments from Dr. Corey Gold, but I just got to say this. We're hiring two new reporters, and each person is going to win $5,000 a piece. We're going to hire a male reporter and a female reporter. The contest is $5,000 for the two winners, and then that puts you in the running to be a reporter. Obviously, we got to negotiate if you can move here, how much you want to be paid, all that kind of stuff. We probably had like 50 or 60 entries. Some of them are pretty good, but there's only four rules, and people aren't following those. And then people are complaining, well, I don't want to upload to YouTube. I want to do it to my server so I get the traffic. Okay, well, you don't want to be a reporter here. You don't want to win $5,000. I mean, it is crazy. It's simple contest rules. Like, why is it only YouTube? Because we can't post 10 videos on the same page if it's different sites. It just doesn't work. Or, I'm really tired of it, folks. And we want your video to go viral on InfoWars.com and on YouTube. The whole point of the contest isn't just to find great reporters. It's also to see all the great reporting you're going to do to wake people up about the New World Order. And there's stuff like have InfoWars in the report. Instead, people do reports about their news thing. You don't want to work here? You don't want to win? That's right. When they don't do what I tell them around here, it's called a joke that the staff's having victories over me. You don't get to ignore everything I say until you work here. That's when you get to do that. Okay, that's... All right, anyways, InfoWarsTeam.com. You go to InfoWars.com/reporter-contest, or just type in InfoWars Reporter Contest into the search engine. It comes up. We're going to start posting videos on the site. We got four entries that follow the rules. It's only been out a few days. They're great. Thank you. You're in the running. And we send people their videos back and go, this is a good video. Will you remake it under the rules? They're like, no. Well, I guess you don't want to win then. I mean, what's the point of entering a contest? Coca-Cola has contests, you know, and then they show it in movie theaters, short films. What if you sent one in and it wasn't about Coca-Cola? You're like, I didn't win the contest because it isn't about Coca-Cola, Jack. I'm sorry. Doc, I'm sorry I'm ranting. You only have like a minute and a half left. Great job joining us. Any other little tidbits we need to know about moves to try to restrict vitamin and mineral sales?
No, I was enjoying that quite a bit. The first thing is you know, don't abrogate your responsibility for your own health. You know, I know people who take better care of their car. They know when to change their oil. They know when to do maintenance on their car, rotate their tires, but they don't know a thing about their body and how it works. They know more about how to reboot their computer than they do about their body. I mean, your body is your most important thing, and God bless you if you have children. Take care of them as well. They depend upon you. So make sure they're getting the right nutrition they need. You told them InfoWars Team is a good place to start on all that. If you have questions, call that number. But yeah, don't make somebody else responsible for your health. Be in tune with your body. Drink good water. Put good air around you. Eat good food and have good fellowship. That'll be the good place to start.
Well said. And I final comment from you. Do you agree they're coming after vitamins, food, raw milk right now because they know it's getting popular and they want to shut it down?
I think they're going to try, but we're going to stop them.
Absolutely. Dr. Corey Gold, thank you so much for spending time with us.
Thank you, Alex.
All right, we got a big retransmission coming up. Oh, my gosh, so much. Wow.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear